All right, everybody, it's our Clout here, and this and a particularly critical video that I'm going to present to you today, and there's a lot to discuss. And let me state at the outset here that the primary purpose is to both present and walk you through what I now call the PEZ theory, and by the end of this video, it's going to be astoundingly clear to you as to why that is the title that I have eventually come upon here, and I'm going to show you how I feel it is more or less all-encompassing theory for the information that I have looked into over the past several months here, everything ranging from the deaths of presidents and celebrities to famous albums and institutions and monuments put in place, the people behind them. And in any case, we've been cross-checking all of that with tarot cards and gematria and a number of other occult research methods and just basic symbology breakdowns of a number of seals and logos. And in any case, at the end of the day, this theory seems to not only have a steady place in all of that, but also in what I feel is to come in the near future here. Now, with that being said, before I get into discussing that theory, and it is lengthy, so prepare for that for all of you who just adore my voice, but I really feel that there's no better way to preface this monumentally important set of ideas that I want to put forward to you today then by addressing the fact that the last video that I put out was banned arbitrarily. Alright, and I'm going to talk about that, but in this video, and as you can clearly see in the flyer, and for those of you who have been watching my channel for a while now know, June 11th is one of a handful of dates that I had been talking about having significant ritualistic and occult significance towards ushering in the new age. And in particular, in this episode, I was talking about the Ricky Smiley skit, the Walk With Me Lord, Granny, Someone Shot in the Right Eye, all of that. Again, things I've been talking about for a while now. I'll show you some information here substantiating the fact that June 11th is a date that I've been talking about for a number of weeks now. But in any case, as is the theme in all of these videos I've been doing, the purpose of presenting these occult dates to you is in conjunction with a series of events including high-profile assassinations and otherwise intensely catastrophic events that are in place to overturn the way that we perceive things. Now, on June 11th, can someone please tell me what happened? Right? A famous singer, I think Kristen Graham, was shot, and then the killer, I believe, committed suicide. And then at 2:02 the next morning, we had what is now being hailed as the biggest terrorist attack in the United States since 9/11. Of course, I'm referring to the Pulse nightclub shooting in Orlando, Florida. And so I know you want to get semantical with me and say that it was June 12th and not the 11th. I understand that. People are very, very, very apprehensive towards this information. But bear in mind that I live on the West Coast. And so on June 11th at 11:02, or maybe it was 11:30, but 2:02 is the time in the story. In any case, still before midnight, I got the CBS News Bulletin update saying that there had been a mass shooting there. And so that's still June 11th for me. And in this video, I was talking about this date in connection to a number of things, and I'm going to elaborate a little bit on it, since usually I can just tell you to go watch the previous video, but this one was clearly banned. I was noting in this video that June 11th was the day after FEMA's large Cascadia Rising exercise was due to conclude. And that June 11th was a date that was 141 days away from when Donald Trump said that he could shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue and not lose any voters. So I'm going to talk more about that in a second. But I want you to see here for this strike, the fact that they say that there is audiovisual content that violated some sort of copyright terms. Know that I used no audiovisual content. This is just like what happened on my original channel. When videos start to get steam or are clearly packing way too much heat behind them, even though only a fraction of the people that watch these are able to comprehend it even close to the scale that it should be resonating on, that's still too many for how clear some of these videos make it. Notice here when it says manually detected, it is because since there was no audiovisual content and they couldn't flag it in the processing phase of uploading a video, just when they're scanning it for any sort of copyright, somebody actually went through, and since I just had used an image from the show Celebrity Deathmatch, Viacom said, you can't have this up. And so as you see here, I cut the screenshots there from where I had used that, but I am going to launch board off of that. Because remember in that episode I was discussing Donald Trump having been on Celebrity Deathmatch versus Don King. And so let's take a look back here. Let me give you a little bit of a refresher. Take a look here for MTV's Celebrity Deathmatch, and I'll put some sort of link to the image that I got this from, but this was from a blog, and it does have an image of Don King versus Donald Trump. Now notice the English and simple values come up 2016 as well as January 23rd. All right, the day in which Trump said he could shoot someone and not lose voters. Notice January 23rd, the first month, 1, 2, 3. If we mirror that 1, 2, 3 and add it to itself, we get this 444 here, which is critical because it is back and forth associated with the order of Thelema. Now, before I trace that out further for you, notice here still for MTV Celebrity Deathmatch, you have two different codings here. Now, I want to show you both of these because they're both exceptionally pertinent towards today's video. The first one you see is 144,000, and I'm going to tell you to lock this away in your memory for a second here, but do notice that it is the same value for 411 Elm Street, which is absolutely where Kennedy was assassinated. You see reference to For Whom the Bell Tolls, the Illuminati Project, Golden Dawn, Hermetic Order, Edward Alexander Crowley, and 777. This is an incredibly important number. Alright, and so the other code, just so I can show you here and we can all be sure, is 1044. So 1044. Now when we pop this in, I want you to notice that it comes up with quite a few things, but what I'm going to draw your attention to explicitly is that it is the same values as Dorothy Parker, which is the song that Erykah Badu covered of Prince's at the Webby Awards, and I did a video on that. But it is also the same as Walk With Me, Lord, and The Wait Is Over. And do remember, Walk With Me, Lord is the song that Ricky Smiley sings at the end of the skit with somebody being shot in the right eye or whatever in the prank phone call. And The Wait Is Over is from the flyer for this June 11th show here. All right, and I showed you how Verizon Arena is connected with the AAA and all of those things. This thing was backwards and forwards airtight. That's absolutely 110 why they did not want you to see this. Alright, and I'm going to do a whole separate video and show you how the coding from this whole report now that they're putting out with the stories going with those events that happened on June 11th, how it fits with all of this that I've shown you here and more. But do also notice here for The Wait Is Over, this triple number sequence 444. Alright, that is absolutely just like the triple four that we get from when Trump said that he would shoot somebody, or could shoot somebody, excuse me, on Fifth Avenue and not lose votes. Now notice here that since it's in connection to this June 11th show here, the number of days between when he said that and that show is 141. So notice that that 141 value is the same as on the ground, which were the last words of Charles Dickens. So if you take a look at that with the value down here, you do see direct reference to Will of Thelema, Age of Aquarius, and 21. You also see reference to Underground, Dark Molester, and the Devourer next to Hairbringer of Death. And I'll talk about all of that and the Gothard Base Tunnel and all the things I had covered in that previous video that we now don't get to see right now, okay? So with that as a bit of a preface here to cater us into the video today, let's start with the PEZ theory coming into play at the baseline of Lisa the Iconoclast. Now, this PEZ theory has 66 points to it. It's an incredibly important number, and that is not something that I intentionally designed into it. It was the number of points when I went through and put the numbers down. FYI, the PEZ theory is also a title that came to me after putting all of this together and thinking and meditating on it for at least a couple of weeks here as I've been building on all of this research. So what I want you to see here for Lisa the Iconoclast, let's start with the fact that it's episode number 144 in the series. Now, we've talked extensively about the number 144 and the number 44 being the kill number, the magic number. It will come up again today, but so do notice here to begin branching this over into this PEZ theory, and remember, you will not completely understand this until the end of the video, but that the original logo was made up of 44 brick-like Pez candies. There's a reason for that. It's not coincidental. Do not write it off. We'll come back to it. Notice for Lisa the Iconoclast is season 7, episode 16. These are two incredibly important numbers even on their own. 7 being the number for the Mark of the Beast and Seal of Babylon, 16 being the Tower Tarot card, as well as reducing down to 7. So it gives us this nice 77 right there. Now let me take another moment here just to go ahead and expand on this, because I want you to see for 77 here, and as this is about to come up, if you add 44 to 77, as we have the episode in the series and this reduction here, you get the number 121. And when we're looking into the written out format of that, do notice here that you get spelled out 121, as well as Nation Wreckers, The Secret Revealed, and Satanic Worship. Now up top there you do see reference to Satanic Conventions, and I highly advise you to look into the work that I've done on JFK and MLK, their assassinations, how they are deeply interwoven into all of this. But so now, notice here for 121, and this is a number that we're going to talk about extensively today, but it is the same as the Athenium and Cromulent. Now, these are things that you'll become more familiar with today. Notice that Cromulent is one of the two words that were made up for this episode. This is an incredibly important concept, and we'll talk about it more. But so here is the painting, the 1796 Gilbert Stuart painting of George Washington, also known as the Athenium, and it plays an integral role in this episode. And we'll talk about that as we get into it later. But so notice that though. Notice as well that it's the same as John Edwards, who from the Celebrity Deathmatch video is the one who gets his head cut off and writes, "Beware the T, beware the Aeon." All of that that I had talked about. You also see Antichrist and Erica Wright. It's Erica Badu's real name next to Tortoise, her character in the upcoming movie The Land, which is going to be coming out on July 29th. And that date is exceptionally important. I put a lot of emphasis on it over the last couple of weeks here, and I want you to know that will come up a lot today as we go on and give even more credibility to it. Now, notice there as well that 121 is also the same Jewish value as J. Adams, connecting this all into the Earth Space Defense Program, which is just very, very bizarrely hammed up next to the Independence Day movie coming out. And again, things that I've talked about in the past. But I want to set as much of a precedent and baseline here as possible so you can see just from that how much it already connects in here. Now, let's take it one step further because I know everybody is so exceptionally critical. If you reduce this down, this 144 to 44, and take it down one more, we get 16 again, the Tower card. Reducing it down gives us this 7, and so when we put it next to the season and episode number, it gives us this 777. So now, remember I told you to log away that code 11440, whatever it was in the beginning there? The reason was, for this 777, you do absolutely see it coming up in that coding for that. And again, the references to the Illuminati Project, Golden Dawn, the Large Hadron Collider accident, and you see it highlighted there. 777. Now, keep in mind that this coding also comes up for the phrase, it could happen to you, which is on the poster for in the Truman Show, on the plane being struck by lightning. You also see reference here to the Brotherhood of Darkness. So all of this, absolutely very ominous, and the 777 is something that I've looked into very extensively. Because it comes up here, notice for Charles Dickens, because he's come up so much in the research, I'll reiterate the C and D from his name. When we add them, we get 7. Both of his names are 7 letters. We have that 777 there. Do notice down below the reference to the Order of Thelema. All of this stuff just magnificently coded in for you there. But so notice for 642 as well, you see reference to the Freemason beast called 777. I remember 642 is in reference to House Resolution 642, just to preserve magic as a national treasure. And again, I've talked extensively about that. But do notice as well with that reference to Freemason beast called 777, Crowley's work, Kabbalistic writings here, what I honestly feel to be a more dry work of his, but very critical nonetheless. So I would absolutely urge you to familiarize with it to an extent so you can see how important that connection is to be sitting in there like that, all right? So now, all of this, I could really go on, and we're just standing at the brink of this episode here. So let's actually jump in and start taking a look here. I want you to see, because I have quite a bit pulled up for you here today, that this episode, and so I guess I'll just cue this up and let's jump back over. Let's break down the title of the episode first here, all right? So point number one, Lisa the Iconoclast. So you see reference to Dial M for murder, as well as Barack H. Obama, I, and the three threes. Now, I also see reference to causing despair and bubonic plague. And one of the ideas that I want to put forward today is that I feel that with all of the things that I've seen for CDC coding and biological warfare and vaccinations being tainted, and just the capacity and the developments that are in the biomedical field that we are not even aware of, this is something on the old channel I talked about pretty extensively, but I would like to posit the idea that the mark of the beast could absolutely be in reference towards having received certain vaccinations and not knowing what the long-term ramifications of those will be. Now, it's a very complex and intriguing idea. I do want to posit that for you, all right? And so now notice here as well for the English and simple values, and I'm going to state this once at the beginning here, when you see the same as, it's things I've looked into in the past. So if you were to watch previous videos of mine, when I talk about the 9 Years' War and why England slept, you would get more elaboration on the 9 Years' War being from Aldous Huxley's Brave New World, said to take place in 2049 if we were to convert to a Gregorian calendar, which is 33 years from where we are now. And so, all immensely interesting. Why England Slept is a book that Kennedy wrote in response to a book that Winston Churchill had wrote. Tom, Sarah, and Usher is connected to LaShawn Thomas, who I showed you with Sade. all of those things, and you also see the Jewish value there being the same as MTV Animation, which is absolutely who put out Celebrity Deathmatch, all right? So that's the kind of depth and complexity that you get just with the same as there. And so now the down below that I show you are things that elaborate further on that. So notice here, Donald John Trump coming up, as well as Secret Art Master, Book of Revelation, The Powers That Be, and The Word of Thoth. Now, notice as well here you see reference to the Masterpiece Ion. And so I want to just show you that this is something that has been coming up since I started doing all of this research and going back to Horatio Greeno. And so notice the V there, and remember I was just referencing Winston Churchill, very common for him to have the peace sign in a lot of his pictures, and I've discussed at length the ties that the V sign, the peace sign, has to support for Apophis and Typhon, who are ancient deities, and Typhon more exclusively being directly connected with being really the most feared god slash demon in all of Greek mythology. And so be sure to read up on him and the connections to volcanic eruptions, activities that he has mythologically, even the origin story of him actually being more powerful than Zeus, in the irony of his creation. And so it is all just very complex and always so interesting to read up on. But so do remember that Horatio Greeno is the man who designed the enthroned Washington statue. And so let me show you that really quick. And the number 22 is going to come up a lot today. And so I just also want to be sure to note that Eliphas Levi, as you can see here, a very, very important occult figure, author, ceremonial magician. It's the guy who came up with this Goat of Mendes. He was 22 years old when Horatio Greeno put this forward, as you see here, this year, 1832, being 22 years from when Levi was born. So absolutely stunning to think about. Notice as well with George Washington's birthday, because we're going to talk about him a lot. February 22 gives us that nice triple two right there. And again, immense importance that we will clarify as we continue to move here. But so again, that 22 being referential not only to the day that Kennedy was assassinated, on the 22nd of November, but also the pass on the Tree of Life, the major Trump tarot cards, the Master Builder number, it has huge connotations, the Age of Aquarius, and really on and on. And so again, you do see with all of these things, noticing back to Horatio Greeno over there, the Mark of the Beast, as well as by the hand of Nema, which remember is the divine word inverted, amen, and as an organization which I have talked about extensively as having something to do with orchestrating a whole host of things. They happen to have this year's mid-year forum in Alexandria, Virginia, which is the same location as the George Washington National Masonic Museum, I believe it's called, or Memorial, located on Shooter's Hill, something else I've talked about a lot recently. And so there's a lot that goes into all of this, and the connections are really just intensely, intensely thick, okay? And so now notice here, let's keep moving here. And so when it says see the Masterpiece Ion, and notice for Lisa the Iconoclast coming up as that exact piece. Iconoclast, for those of you not familiar with the word, defined as a person who attacks cherished beliefs or institutions. Now, particular generally refers to a destroyer of images used in religious worship. So now remember, one of the keystones I've talked about with all of this, the idea that the whole point of this is to overturn the dogmas which currently hinder the extent of the reality we're able to conventionally acknowledge and experience. And so there's a lot that goes in with that, and I don't want to get too sidetracked on it, so let's keep going here. Notice the word iconoclast has the same Jewish value as formation, shade, bring me home, and treason, something I'll talk about later. But of course, formation being the lead single off of Beyonce's album, and what most of you are most familiar with me for looking into at this point. But note those things and how important it is that they'll keep coming up. You see again a satanic mark, golden ratio, book of beasts, and I want you to see this tick, tick, tick. All right, because notice it's four-letter words starting with T, reducing to two. We could add those as four and two is six, giving us a triple six. I'm going to show you ticking time bomb later, but notice as well, bloodstain and the price of life. All right, so now down below here, you do see the English in simple values, the triple six and the triple one. It's important to note you will become familiar with Clara Rising today. She is the woman responsible for wanting to exhume the body of Zachary Taylor, who this episode is actually referencing when they exhumed Jebediah Springfield. And Chief Wiggum, as I will discuss, is the person who exhumes the body. So already the fact that in the episode and in real life the names have the same coding and it's 666, 111 is phenomenal. Notice as well, it's the same as Formation, Save the Bees, and TMZ Staff. So do remember for Save the Bees that that is off of Erykah Badu's most recent outing here off of the cover underneath Control Freak Records. That is her record label, but you see her here in the Shiva format, really very neon colors, ultraviolet. But that Save the Bees and Control Freak, and I'm going to talk about those again later on. But so notice here all of the things you see coded with that. And so let's keep moving here, though. And so for the actual episode production code for this, and it's crucial to look at this all the way through here, it's 3F13. And so those are very important numbers all the way through. So if we put that down just like it's written there, do see that you get reference to Luciferian face, the Goshia Klipoth. Now, do remember that there are 72 demons in that book, and that Crowley was 72 at his age of death. Of course, if you invert it, you get the highly important 27, which will come up later today. Adding that mirror of 27 and 72 gives you 99. Again, one of the most important numbers imaginable in this coding. But see as well, CIA murderer, as well as Pale Horse Rider, Snuff Films, and Thelema Magus. Now remember, Magus is the fully developed fool. And so for everybody downplaying that role, that character, do remember that if you actually study the tarot deck, you know that the fool is the one who goes to essentially have control of the universe, all right? To become the Magus, to be right, to be wrong, to be humble, to be just, to be all these things, the dualities, the singularities of it in one person. It is really, it's stunning to think about. But in any case, notice the English in simple values here, again, supremely important. Reference to the 9 Years' War, Bradbury and Evans, that's Charles Dickens' publisher, as well as ALZ21CCO. Now, this will be critical and everything. Do remember this was from the crane operator video that I did, talking about the threat that was put forward to Beyonce. Notice that's the screen name from Austin Zamora. And notice as well, written by TMZ staff, all of those things that we've already been discussing in this. But so again, you do see reference to 36 and Truman Show. Remember, that is the house he lives in. I've shown you that in a number of videos now. 36 is also the 36 triangular number is 666. Again, something I say entirely too much here, but notice as well, same as the Path of Teth, that is the lust card, the 11th card. You also see the all-seeing eye. The numbers 421, which are the coding for Pasadena, California. You also see the secret sign, Masonic imagery, veiled allegory, and ticking time bomb. So there's coming back to tick, tick, tick for you now. I want to talk a little bit about this. So notice with all of this, Pasadena, California's coding, this idea of the endpoint. Do you notice the English in simples there? Same as Dallas trademark. It's where Kennedy was heading when he was assassinated, as well as David Copperfield. That's the 8th book by Charles Dickens. Do remember in House Resolution 642, Copperfield is mentioned by name 8 times. 8 is an incredibly important number, is the adjustment card in the tarot deck. Previously, the justice card in traditional decks, but Crowley believed that there is no such thing as justice in nature, only adjustment, because nature is not subjective in its interpretation of what is right and wrong. There is only adjustment to what it is that survives. So notice again that you see Skull and Bones 66 coming up, the Path of Resh, again, the Sun card. what I honestly think most of this boils down to in being support for. And what I want to show you here, since Pasadena's come up so much, do remember I originally flagged this with Beyonce playing the Rose Bowl show there on the 14th, a couple of months ago. And so remember on that same day, Anthony Kiedis had to go to the ER before headlining in Irvine, California, and the Washington Monument, the world's tallest obelisk at 555 feet, was closed due to elevator problems, all right? And remember all the coding I showed you for 555 and Purple Rain? Of course, everybody knows the thing that Prince said about the elevator being the devil. So you see these connections directly tied in with what I've been discussing with you. But I want to take another note at this here. So notice Pasadena, California. And remember when Beyonce was playing in Pasadena, it was the 18th day of her tour. And Pasadena, California is the air's 18 letters total between the city and state put together there. Remember, that is the moon card of supreme importance in all of this. But it's also the location of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. So now I want to talk about the JPL for a minute here. And so let's start with the fact that they were founded on Halloween in 1936. Jet Propulsion Laboratory is coded. CERN will tear the fabric of reality. Now, let's pop back here so we can get just a couple of images for this here. So notice JPL, and we're going to go back and talk about how this is something that is controlled by NASA essentially here. But notice here the parent agency managed for NASA by Caltech, all right, the California Institute of Technology. And so let's just take a look back here at the coding for that at Caltech, all right, shares the coding for we are 138 Devil, Nero, and NWO. So remember, we are 138, something again that I've been talking about at length here. That is the lead song off of the Misfits Bullet EP. As you can see, Plain and Simple right there off of Plan 9 Records, something I've talked about endlessly in all of this coding here, but so absolutely fascinating that you see that that is who is running the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. So now take a look here before we talk a little bit about JPL's history. Let's preface it and look at JPL, and the coding for that is the same as the Zodiac. Guardian of the Path, 66, again, incredibly important. You can see it flagged right next to us here and all of the coding next to that. But you see Life from the Stars, America Pays, True False Idols, The Satanic Cult, Nuclear Ambitions, and The Eye of Pan. Now, I want to flag Nuclear Ambitions because it is absolutely critical to do so. Take a look back here. It says, during JPL's Army years, the laboratory developed two deployed weapon systems, the MGM-5 Corporal and MGM-29 Sergeant Intermediate Range Ballistic Missiles. These missiles were the first U.S. ballistic missiles developed at JPL. And so notice that's all it really says about them. It kind of brushes them off as intermediate range ballistic missiles. And so for those of you who don't know what those missiles are, because I didn't know what they were off the top of my head, and how they're so nonchalantly mentioned, you wouldn't really think anything of it. But when you look into them, the MGM-5 Corporal was the first guided weapon authorized by the United States to carry a nuclear warhead. The MGM-29 Sergeant was then the next one to take the place of that. Now, these are both missile types that are allegedly deactivated now, but that doesn't change the fact that Jet Propulsion Laboratory developed those. In that NASA, who went on to acquire JPL, has that knowledge in their repertoire. And so that ties directly back with JPL and Nuclear Ambitions. Let's break this down one more way for you here. JPL reduces down to 173, and I know this coding comes up later in the PEZ theory here, so do notice that 173 It's the same as Third World War, Agenda 21, Demonic Martial Law, Master of the Lodge, and 107. A number that by this end of this video, you will be just supremely stunned by. And so, let me jump back here really quick. Some reason I just got nervous for the fact that I don't know that I played these content disclaimers. I might have to put them back somewhere in the beginning of this video here. But let's get back to the coding. So NASA was formed in the wake of the National Aeronautics Space Act being passed on July 29th, 1958. And so that's 729. That's the number that I've been looking into immensely over on my end, and it is coded with the idea of the last day, and I've done a lot looking into the different ways of breaking it down. You see on the right there, it coming up with the ideas of 77, 99, all of these things breaking down again and again. So it will be 58 years this year since NASA was officially founded with the passing of that National Aeronautics Space Act. So note that 58 is absolutely, and it's going to come up in the end of the video here, but when we add it together, we do absolutely get 13, the death card. And so with all of that, very interesting, okay? Very, very interesting. And so if we jump back here, because NASA is absolutely no spring chicken, and they just come across as so devious. And the reason is when they inherited everything from the NACA, you see that the elements of the Army Ballistic Missile Agency and the United States Naval Research Laboratory were incorporated into this. And you also see that they were getting people who were working for the Army Ballistic Missile Agency. And so it's very important to mind all of that. And then later in the same year that they're founded, that they inherit the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. All right, in December of 1958. Just a few months after. All right, so very, very fascinating stuff here. So take a look here, because you notice that them grabbing JPL in December means that it was then JPL's 22nd year in operation. All right, and again, everything that I've said with the number 22 just moments ago with Levi and everything with that. Okay, so with all of that, let's get back to this original air date here for Lisa the Iconoclast. It's February 18th, 1996, all right? 1 and 8 is 9. That's this right here. 2, okay? 2 and 9 is 11. This year, the way I reduce comes down to 7. So you have this 117, which you can reduce down to 77 again. So notice for the couch gag on this particular episode of The Simpsons, all right, and all these disclaimers now, is it depicted from a scene from the Brady Bunch here. So the Brady Bunch is very important. Do notice that TBB is absolutely 222, just like George Washington's birth date, February 22nd. All right, very important because he's an integral role in all of this. I also want you to see the number of letters for this, 355. Very important because that is the same Jewish value for Lincoln Financial Field, which is where Beyonce is going to be playing on September 29th. It is also the length of the recently completed Gothard Base Tunnel. All right, so now let's pull that up for a second here. Let's look at this at the Gothard Base Tunnel. If I can find it in this hodgepodge of links for you here. So, do remember that the opening ceremony for this took place on June 1st, 2016. This is from the BBC. I'm going to look at this tweet and everything in a moment here, because tweets are absolutely imperative towards understanding hidden, veiled pieces of this, the ones they choose for the stories, the times, so on and so forth. But so notice there's a baseline here that the Gothard Tunnel, which is in Switzerland, And Beyonce's show at the Lutzengrund, which is also in Switzerland, on July 14th, have a difference of 44 days in between them. Alright, that incredibly important number. 1 month, 14 days. 114, 411, 44. All the things from that. Incredibly critical to keep in mind. And so when we look into that 11th live ritual, as well as V-shaped forehead mark, the Typhoonian cult, remember everything I've said, linking the V to that particular god slash monster, as well as war and death. And so you'll notice below that the post, the person who posted that tweet, Fabian Pericento, however you pronounce that, apologies, but that has the same English and simple value as Don King slash Donald Trump. And so do remember that that was absolutely the match from Celebrity Deathmatch that I was looking into, warning you. You see the Department of Defense, as well as the call date, October 2nd, which is the other date that I was looking in between with Trump. If we just jump back here, and I can show you very plainly that I had been looking at October 2nd, and June 11th in connection to each other, 114 days apart, 3 months, 22 days. That skull and bones number is 66. This is 44, two of the most critical numbers. This is something I've been talking to you since at least May 21st. I know I've been mentioning these dates sooner than that, especially Beyonce's now ending tour date. Alright, but so these connections are so immensely important and astounding. Notice here, an occult conspiracy, all is not as it seems, an apocalypse scenario, reference to the Manhattan Project, fits in with everything we were talking about with JPL's nuclear background, the number of the devil, and he who ends humanity. Now I'll show you through and through today how all of these things come up with the devil and 666 and do with that what you will, but know that the coding that it comes up with is immensely important to keep in mind for the symbolical reference for this and the metaphorical and allegorical references that it is all really orchestrated on. All right, so now all of that, supremely important. And let's jump back over here to the left side of your screen now, looking at the Brady Bunch and all of these things here. Notice fictional reality. Hadron Collider disaster, strange sense X. Remember that there was that weird thing in the Beyonce is the Jesus fucking Christ video that I did. In it, Beyonce is, there's a reference to her as Beyonce X. And look at this, the three sixes, U.S. Babylon, end of days, the word, propaganda, going home. All of these things, holy sacred force, see day of reckoning, that's something we'll be told to look at again today. But notice again the 888 coming in there, the demonic elite, sublime new era, all these concepts I've elaborated on immensely in the past for you. So now notice here, let's go back to the left side of your screen, the English and simple values are the same as Charles Dickens and the Boondocks. Again, who LaShawn Thomas was an animator for and did the tweet about Sade needed to be checked on the day that Prince died. Also having the same coding as Antichrist or the Antichrist. Notice as well here Charles Dickens, again everything I've talked about already in this video with him. You see reference now to John F. Kennedy, death penalty, serial killer, and the great beast. All of that, plain as day, couldn't be more clear. So now, let's take a look at the next piece here. This is written by Jonathon Collier. Alright. Notice for his coding, you see reference to I Am Your Master, Continental Drift Disasters, Children of the Devil, the Satanic Illuminatus, and the Key to the Gate of Babylon. His English and simple values are the same as the PEZ Theory. Let Him March, Boys, Police Chief Wiggum, and Sunset Sound. Now, the two in the middle there, you will understand as we get to the end of this video. Notice the great architect, the number 7. Again, just tying it in, that's the number of dates that Beyonce added to her tour, as well as everything else that I've told you with that number. Notice as well, hiding the truth, order of the rose, the Rosicrucians, which the Rose absolutely having symbolism of secrecy and the secrets of everything of divinity, of that which is beyond the veil. You also see reference to just wait and see, Obama executioner in the smoking jacket. Now, in this episode, Lisa discovers that Jebediah was actually a crooked pirate whose name was Hans Sprungfeld. And if you look this up, it is coded for pretending to be a hero. Remember, Jebediah is the founder of Springfield. It's like George Washington. It's hailed. Jebediah has that same exact thing. This is an allegorical story for all of this. For Jebediah's name, you see religious idols, Obama shot and reborn, as well as Bill and Hillary. And I'm going to show you how they're connected later on here. Notice his English and simple values. The simple is 44. All right. And so again, remember that the original PEZ logo, it's 44 bricks. And think back to what PEZ logos are and think to what the Simpsons opening intro is now, all right? It is Jimbo and Kearney, and I'm going to talk about this towards the end, but sawing the neck, right? What is a Pez dispenser? It is a head on a stick, all right? And candy comes out of the throat. But they're opening up his neck. And notice here with Kennedy, but it falls then onto Ralph. And notice with this frame here with Kennedy grabbing his neck. And this is the one spot where I'll let you say that this is me really following intuition and really going with it. So notice here that 254 days or 8 months and 10 days, that same number, 254, right back here for this Kennedy bit. It's the same amount of time from when Trump said he could shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue to the date of October 2nd, the finishing of Beyonce's tour. So that 254 in that 810 and everything we're talking about, know that 810 is absolutely the coding for Ralph Wiggum and the I Slay remix, the exceptionally popular remix of Beyonce's Formation song. East 83 is from the trailer for The Land with Erykah Badu, something I've talked about extensively, but take a look. Terrorism, Thelemic Order, Bohemian Grove, God of Baphomet, The Radiance of God. You also see these references to Wall Street and the stock exchange, obviously something to do with money, and all of this is to be expected. But do you see how that comes in there? That is just absolutely phenomenal. But so notice for 264, all right, it's the same value, the same simple value as I got hot sauce in my bag swag. All right, take a look at that. As well as five words he didn't even mean. And this ties back to the Austin Zamora story. But so notice here, this 333, 26 symbols, it's our alphabet, 22 letters, right? The Hebrew alphabet, the tarot cards, you see the 4th and the 11th Internal Revenue Service, all of these things coming in connection with each other, shadow government, all right, on and on and on. I want you to see for this 333 and the immense importance that it carries with it here, because one of the things I've talked so much about is Erykah Badu's Window Seat music video in which she's assassinated, in the remix in which she's reincarnated and goes on a killing spree with Rick Ross. This is the cover for the Window Seat single. Notice the Flight 33, excuse me, 333, as well as this hidden 333 right here, which was also the release date of her, I believe, New America Return of the Ankh album. Do remember, I've talked extensively about 26F, 266, the same coding as Representative Pete Sessions, R. Texas, who introduced the magic bill. You see this SS, do remember that, it will come up. Also, of course, its direct connections to Nazis, the 11P, P reducing down there, to the 7, so 11 times 7, giving us either that 77 again, all of our connections we've discussed, P is the 16th letter, though, so if we just hail it out there is 11, 16, triple 1 times 6 is triple 6. Down below 6F is 66. All right, all of this so thoroughly and elaborately coded. And so that's why I show you that 333 there, because it's a number I've talked about a lot, and I want to be sure to give it its proper emphasis. And the fact that since it's on the cover for the single of Window Seat, it is also very important that when we look at 264, it is also the same Jewish value as Cootie Rock, who is the director for that video. I mean, that is just absolutely stunning to think about. Now, take a look back over here, because you can get a glimpse at some of the important things that come up with this coding of 44s. Kill, magic, H-A-A-R-P, all right? The immensely, immensely important institution that a lot of us are worried about. You also see Godhead. Now, let's keep moving here, though, because as I said, there are 66 points, and we're on number 7. And all of this information here, it is just so incredibly important and deep, and just stay with me. So Jebediah Springfield, the founder, all right? Look at all of these ways that his name can be broken down. The 99s that we get from it. The 11 that we get from it. The letters that you see here, this 88 that we can get from it. The sun card. All of these things. Notice the manifestation of Lucifer. And again, with all of the connections that I've been making between Jebediah and Washington and telling you that this is a complete allegorical thing, and all of these connections to this Goat of Mendes and the enthroned Washington statue, the manifestation of Jebediah Springfield here, the manifestation of Lucifer, you see, Conqueror of Nations, the number of the Klipoth, remember, that is the inverse of the Tree of Life, the negative shells, the husks, what is alleged to drive people towards misery, destruction, murder, all of those things, suffering, evil plot, holy number 8, alright, I've talked a lot about, you see, he leads to destruction and we all die. Now notice the English and simple values are the same as Nissan Stadium. This is the venue that Beyonce is going to be playing in on the 2nd of October, that 10-2 date that I've been talking about already so much. You see, it's also the same as Mayor Eric Hogue. And so again, just to be sure, and just to really drive these connections home with David Copperfield and all of that, Mayor Eric Hogue, and he's going to come up a lot later with Obnoxio the Clown from the X-Men. It's going to blow your mind. But that he's very good friends with David Copperfield. Alright, and that since 15 he was dressing as a clown. Right, 15, the devil card. And he's a part of the Dallas Magic Clubs, all of these things. But that he has that coding in common with Jebediah Springfield, with Nissan Stadium, with the seventh seal, with used and abused books, all these things we've talked about. Alright, so take a look here. Barack Hussein Obama, spelled out. Final Antichrist. Eyes wide shut. Rise to power. Barack Obama head wound, as well as Obama gets headshot. Wild, Wild West. Reference to 878. Remember, 878 is something that I've been talking about so incredibly much, because this is where Beyonce is going to be playing on 729. Alright, and you can see the numbers there for how it relates to her tour and the things that I've shown you connected with it. But so that is just incredibly important to get those connections in there and bear Wild Wild West in mind with everything that we talk about as we move forward here, because you're going to see how this all connects, okay? So now, the quote from from Jebediah is, "A noble spirit embiggens the smallest man." That's what's written on the statue that adorns Springfield there out in the lobby. It's back in this one over here. All right. So do notice that it is 7 words. And again, everything we're talking about with the number 7. Can see it there written out for you some more, but reference to the synagogue of Satan, devil in disguise, all things are revealed in war religion. Down below you have 49 gates of the Holy Spirit, 13 richest families in the world, the 44th President Barack Obama, and the propensity to commit violence. So, let's start taking a look at some of the images from this actual episode here. This is how it starts, with a watch and learn feature. Alright, and so it's telling you the history of Jebediah Springfield. It's spoon-feeding the history. This is what's playing in Bart's class. While it's playing, the teachers are in the back smoking, and they're using the made-up words cromulent and embiggen that I referenced at the beginning of this here. But before we get to that, notice for a watch and learn feature, you see reference to the Illuminati religion is a solar phallic cult? Absolutely. You see flight of the Holy Dove, 9/11, hijacking, and a supremacist organization. Now, notice the key phrase is a watch and learn feature, 9/11 hijacking. And I think we're at a point where enough people have doubts about that to where you should see that the fact that a watch and learn feature coming up with 9/11 hijacking and flight of the Holy Dove is far too wild to let go, as well as the supremacist organizations, essentially what the 9/11 attacks were blamed on. Notice as well that the English and simple values here are the same as celebrity deathmatch. Here you see reference to the Divine Triangle, the Word of the Aeon, U.S. President Obama, and Kennedy death curse. Right, you also see Teflon President, which is important because Rick Ross, who goes on the killing spree with Erykah Badu in part 2 of the video, is referred to as a Teflon Don. Somebody who is said to be made of Teflon is somebody who can take intense criticism and not let it really affect them. More or less, U.S. President Obama absolutely embodies that idea. So notice how that is connected. The word cromulent is the same value as the brothers. This is the hidden name for the lover's tarot card, the card related to the idea of the great work. So do notice here you see reference to anagrams and gematria. Anagrams are rearranging letters and words to find hidden words in them, and gematria is the use of noting that each letter has numeric values and that words and phrases, when looked at in terms of their sums, can be said to have deeply interwoven connections, and that is the basis for this system that I am showing you here, all right? So you see reference as well to UN of Satan, FEMA preparations, dishonest NASA, cult leaders, saboteur, spirit of lies, as well as illumination, the dual tree, and illusions. Now, again, as stated in the beginning of this video, the English and simple values for this are the same as the Athenium, John Edwards, Antichrist, Erica Wright, Tortoise, Let It Burn, and Live the Hype. Also the same as Don Trump, Blood Sacrifice, The Great Seal, Seven Seals, Top Secret, and Divine Star. So keep going down below here. Let's take a look back through some of these clips here so I don't leave anything out, because a good portion of this I do want to just show you images from this. And so do notice here, after the watch and learn feature concludes, it ends with the phrase "the end" over the American flag. Now this is very important in connection with everything that I'm saying that this is symbolic of. In this episode, you see here that the Simpsons are ceaselessly clever with their hits at how people just let everything happen. Parade to distract joyless citizenry. It's absolutely where they use our ego and our pleasure to keep us docile. It's a plain fact, and I know everybody wants to be contentious and argue tooth and nail over it, but it's very true. It's very, very, very true. And so, take a look here at the Springfield Historical Society, where the dead come alive, metaphorically. Remember, the baseline for this episode is comparing to the exhumation of former President Zachary Taylor's body. And they're going to exhume Jebediah Springfield's body in trying to dispel a conspiracy about that individual. So now, let's jump back here with that clarified a bit. Notice Springfield Historical Society has the same Jewish value as Charles John Hoffman Dickens. That's Charles Dickens' full name. You see the CIA is a satanic organization, chief angel of worship, Anton LaVey, the founder of the Church of Satan, founded in 1966, 50 years ago. 50-year anniversary of the Super Bowl is this year as well. But do notice as well, you see reference to CERN goes wrong, sudden alien invasion, and two ducks. And so I highly advise you to still watch my Legends of Light video discussing the the presidential dinner, which Steve Bridges appeared next to George Bush as an impersonator. They're talking about the hustling ducks, the two ducks, all right? It's very important. Every time I try to show you clips of that or include it in these videos, I do want you to see that I did intend on having it for you originally today, but every time, and for those of you even who saw my Beyonce video, it doesn't like me trying to show you that, all right? Because it's very important. It was on the 119th day of the year. With 246 days remaining, the inversion of the magic bill number. Remember when you invert and add that magic bill number, you get 888, which is an incredibly important number. Something I cannot overstate enough. All right, so then notice as well here we have reference to July 8th, another date that's been popping up, that 7-8 number of cards in the tarot deck. So very important here. But down below, the English and simple values are the same as the internet was in its feelings. And so again, building immediately off of that 888 importance there, remember when we were looking into this, I pointed out that decoding Beyonce's lemonade is a phrase in which every word is eight letters. And so if my computer will catch up for me here, let's see if we can pull that up for you. All right, so there's that for you, because I do want you to see that it has that coding for the encrypted code as well as 114. Hands that shed innocent blood, all right? All of these things we've been talking about, the deadly cliffoth, our number is 11, so on and so forth, okay? Immensely important. Lisa Respers France, the author of this article, does come up a lot, but in any case, you do see here the story highlights. It says the internet was in its feelings, which is something I looked into a while ago, all right? And so again, just notice everything you see here. Reference to Department of Homeland Security poisoning our food supplies. It's references to 3 days after a full moon, earthquakes, all right? Very important stuff. Very interesting, all right? So I'm breaking down this Springfield sign for you here line by line for a moment. Give me a sec. Now notice, for where the dead came alive, it's the same as Columbia University, which is what I was talking about back in my Family Guy video, and all of the connections. Let me see if I can pull it up for you here. With the Earth Institute there, the concepts of shock economics with the man who runs it, and so on and so forth, all right? So very important to go back and watch that video. But do notice the English and symbols down here, Barack Hussein Obama Jr., as well as code 137, which when we pop that in here, you do see that it comes up as the same as Eye of Horus, as well as the Path of Death, Church of Satan, FEMA camps are real. You see up there, murder music. One of the labels that I was looking into in reference to that, and a lot of other coding next to it. I do also want you to see it has the written out 1368, which does come up quite a bit here. You see it's the hidden values for Beyonce Knowles Carter. Immensely important, because with that you see United States of America, Martin Luther King Jr., as well as the Key of the Rituals, and FEMA concentration camps. And so remember, the Croc Weenie Fest is where Kiedis was supposed to be headlining the day that he had to be rushed to the emergency room for intestinal problems. And so go check that video out that I did. Again, I told you that date was going to be something to look at. And you also had the whole incident with the Washington Monument being closed. So there's a ton there. too much to go into now, but go watch those videos. So look here on the left again now. Push the Envelope, Biblical Occultist, Egyptian Key of Life next to Underground Caves. Remember everything with the Gothard Tunnel we've talked about, as well as the Secret Doctrine. Now take a look down here at Metaphorically. So I want you to see the first thing that comes up is Freemasonry next to 888, that triple eight, again, immensely important, cannot be overstated, as well as another stalling tactic, deadly solar flare, second attack on US, Obama, one-eye beast, as well as Antichrist on an airplane. You see reference to the ancient serpent, which I have possibly as Typhoon, son of the Illuminati, and the meaning of number eight, again. Too much to go into because I'm only on point 13 here. I do want you to see that the English and simple values for Metaphorically are the same as Samuel Hinckley. Now, do remember that Samuel Hinckley is who... let me see, I have it for you right back here. That Obama and Bush are 11th cousins through Samuel Hinckley. This is from a New York Times piece from Nicholas Kristof. Opinion pages on the ground. Charles Dickens' last words. All of the ways I've shown you him coded in here. Remember Missy Elliott, who's going against Beyonce in the Celebrity Deathmatch episode I talked about with that. You also see Austin Zamora. That was the crane operator who threatened to bring the stage down. Solvet Coagula, Dissolution and Coagulation, or Dissolution, excuse me. Key alchemical phrase, it's on the Gotamendi's arms, so on and so forth. All right, now I want you to see entertainment and the phrase double 13 coming up here. And I want you to know that the PEZ theory absolutely seems to be inspired by a plane of thinking that is not something that can be gleaned on this level. Because notice for double 13, oh God, I just fucked it all up there. So go back to 13 for the Metaphorically here. All right, and so notice this, the double 13 coding. I want you to see if we actually type in double 13, it's the same as Camp Town Ladies. And you see the appearance of 11, child snuff film community, warning signs, 153 fish. Now, 153 is the same coding as in the right eye. This is from the Ricky Smiley bit. All right, so notice that. It's going to come up again as well. And fish in the tarot breakdown of things is equivalent to the path of none, which is absolutely the death card. And I want you to think about the idea of nuns in Catholicism and the fact that they chose that name knowing that the systems of the tarot were in place before. All right, and that is the extent that they do absolutely go through. All right. I want you to see I could even mirror that, and that's 11 cubed, which is absolutely a very big deal in all of this. All right, and so you'll also notice that Camp Town Ladies is the inverted 31, and then that 13 where I showed you Metaphorically, right, the double, so on. It's impressive. I'm beside myself even presenting it to you half the time. It's so stunning to me. You see reference to tarot card reading. Tree of Life and Death, Evil President, the number 553, which is again the inversion of the length of the Gothard Base Tunnel. It's also the inversion of the coding for Lincoln Financial Field, which is where, as I've stated, Beyonce is going to be doing her show. And so there's all of that for you, so you can see all of those connections, the 666, the signs. The whole bit for you laid out there, right? And so 354 is the same as TMZ, which of course comes up with a lot of other things that we've talked about as well today, all right? So there's all of that for you. Now, let's keep moving here, because it was speculated that Jebediah's actual cause of death was due to syphilis. So if we take a look at syphilis here, you will notice that it is the same as desolate measure, cruel and inhumane, NASA announcement, the Prince of Darkness, and Beast Inspiration. Now, the English and simple values for this are the same as Fifth Avenue. This is where Trump said he could shoot somebody and not lose voters. Soft Ice Cream, which is a lyric from Lana Del Rey's Salvatore song. And something that I've talked about extensively in the past, in videos, Taken Down. Remember that album came out on September 18th, 1 and 8, 9, the double 9 that we got from that. And all of the immense importance associated with everything there. You see as well that it shares the same coding as Cascadia Rising. And the Cascadia Rising coding, remember the Jewish value for it, is the same as Bullet. The title of that JFK album, or excuse me, the Misfits album in which JFK is being shot in the head. You see there again the reference to 13, the killers, the end of America. All right, reference to the phrase I know and the phrase Judith. And again, remember when I was looking into the band A Perfect Circle and telling you that their Mare de Nome album, which is now the 16-year anniversary of, was indeed a masterful keystone piece that they put out a long time ago to be in accordance with all of this, alright? So now, let's get back to this over here, and I'm going to talk more about the ice cream stuff later on here, and of course, do you remember Cascadia Rising completed the day before the Erykah Badu and Ricky Smiley show, which I directly connected with Fifth Avenue for you earlier. Do as well see this 117, because this is also something that we saw in the original air date for this, alright? So it's important to see how it comes back again and again. But notice, Flesh and Blood, as well as Catholic Shame, Wrath of God, as well as We Come in Peace, and the Seal of God. So now, let's jump back here to our Simpsons bit here, so I can make sure to get everybody in here. And let's take a quick look at Hollis Hurlbut here. And so now, this is a role where if you're looking into the information here, you can see that they state very clearly that this was a part that they had written especially for Donald Sutherland, all right? And so it's important just to know that this was written for him and that Donald Sutherland played Agent X. Remember the importance of when we were talking about that earlier in the JFK movie. And so all of that is very critical here, okay? But do notice HH from Hollis's name, of course, the 88. But you see death for the Antichrist, as well as satanic sororities, people of the Illuminati, and the spirit of Christ. Down below you have speed limit 7, which again is from Erykah Badu's The Land trailer. But do see it is referenced to the mark of the beast. I am the Antichrist, the working Babylon, reference to Prince of Darkness, the doomsday device, the rising of the dead. Again, just thinking back to the actual logo for the Springfield Historical Society, saying where the dead come to life. You also see I in the triangle, Great Deceiver Satan, the apple of my eye, and open the third eye. All right, so now let's take a look. Let's take a look at some of the artifacts that Jebediah has. As Hollis is showing Lisa here, I want to show you this one backed up just a bit here, because down below you have a peace pipe or a paraphernalia pipe, another way to put it, something strongly connected with the occult because of ideas of dissociation from normal states of being. And what that has to do in such a dynamic way is something that you need to look into separately, okay? This is very critical to note, though, that there is this pipe down there. And we're going to look at the other things in here, but so what he's referencing to her is the fife. And so very important, though, because remember, if we're talking about Jebediah Springfield, when we were looking at his coding earlier in this video as being the manifestation of Lucifer, you see that he's showing her the music, first and foremost, the Pied Piper, so on. I can't fully make this out, but it looks like it says in an inverted manner, UN, as well as some sort of version of a 9/11, or something in Hebrew. But it absolutely is connected in some way. But amongst the other artifacts that he shows her is his hatchet. And again, thinking back to The Shining, all of the connections that I had discussed with that, the fact that that was the last video that I put out on my original channel before they arbitrarily suspended my channel and took it all away. And the other piece that he shows her is his, what he refers to as bedpan, but what is clearly a cauldron, clearly a black cauldron. And it's especially potent with all of these connections to occultism, Luciferianism, Wiccans, the whole nine. Alright, that he has a black cauldron, a hatchet, a pipe, a fife, all of that. Notice behind Lisa in this same scene, you see this very clear Masonic compass over here. The scales of law clearly leaning on this side. And so all of that, absolutely critical to bear in mind here. Now, in the episode, when Hollis leaves the room to get his Johnny Cakes, Lisa grabs the fife, and when she blows on it, she sees hidden inside the hidden confession of Jebediah Springfield. And so one of the big pieces of this is that it is written on a piece of the Athenium that was being worked on by Stewart, and I'm going to get into all of that. But so she goes into this flashback where Jebediah is writing the letter. So notice on where he appears, he always has these two X's on him, the 24th letter. All right, remember, 2 and 4 is obviously 6, so 6, 6, the double 6 is something I've talked about emphatically throughout this video. So it should be clear to you how important that is, that he has that. So notice in here, he's claiming, you know, he's not claiming, he's revealing the truth in that he's lying to everybody and that they're a bunch of idiots and that he's a pirate and that he's there only to deceive them. And he's drinking from a skull while he's writing this letter, all right? And so after she reads it and Hollis comes back and he's asking her what was going on, she obviously hides it and it cuts back to this scene. But check this out, because this is, right, the case they were just looking in with his possessions. But why is there a modern-day gun? Alright? Why is there a modern-day gun? And why is there modern-day currency? Very, very wild to think about. Alright? It's very, very stunning, alright? And so Lisa says that she didn't find anything and places it back in the fife, and then she goes and starts doing her research. And so, I don't have the clip for you here, or the image, but it's a reference here to a Kennedy bit, the Lee Harvey Oswald stuff, with the side-by-side comparison, and I'll show you the Wanted for Treason poster, and how that's the direct reference here. But the point here is 107, because that's the number of the plate for the prosthetic tongue that Jebediah Springfield has. And so this is the biggest secret, and really the smoking gun that Lisa comes across for Jebediah. This is her finding the idea that if she can prove the existence of this silver tongue, then she can prove to everybody that everything before them is based on lies. All right, now this is a keystone concept here. So notice when we start breaking this down, plate 107, you see hidden existence outside of reality. The Large Hadron Collider is a weapon. Wait until September. Remember, that will be the 245th day. It will be a Thursday in there, something I've talked about quite a bit in the past. You see reference to the Master, the Man of God, the Great Initiate, the Anointed One. That's all one phrase. You see Star of Satan, 666. And the phrase, I am better at gematria than the devils. Now down below you see the English and simple values are the same as the mysterious T, and that is the episode of Celebrity Deathmatch in which Missy Elliott goes against Beyonce Knowles. It's the same as I choose you, which is the Valentine's Day card that Lisa gives to Ralph in the episode where he plays George Washington, and that's what I'll be talking about towards the end of the video. It's also the same as 1781, which you'll see here in just a moment, and the Queen of Neo Soul, which is a reference towards Erykah Badu yet again. So do notice here you have reference to Master Mason's War, Declaration of Independence, and Ordo Summum Bonum, which is good order. Notice for plate 107, you have to pay the devil, the ancient word of God, the mighty Zeus, FBI is spying on you, and show me a sign, Satan. So the English and simple values then down below is the same as Missy Elliott slash Beyonce, which is how their battle appears when it is listed in the episode, The Mysterious T. You'll also note that it's the same as inspired by Matt and Kim and the Liberator of the Mind. And so this is definitely another important break for images to show you here, because remember that the Window Seat music video starts with the phrase inspired by Matt and Kim, and I've shown you extensively the Matt and Kim connections in all of that. And you know what? Unfortunately, it doesn't look like I have the Liberator of the Mind, the Queen of Swords tarot card up here. But look it up, because it is a woman holding the head of a man decapitated. All right, tying it even further back into this PEZ theory. So you see then here, Illuminati bloodlines, Antichrist calculator, truth behind the scenes, reveal the hidden truth, sealed with seven seals. 17 times 6, which gives us the number 102, which you could absolutely look at as 10-2, as in October 2nd, date that I've been talking about a lot. But so notice here, the silver tongue, like I said, is what Lisa is trying to prove the existence of in order to show that Jebediah is a fraud. And when she finds it, this is at the end of the episode, and notice here, this wild, wild west setting that it's in. I want you to see the cowboy. I want you to see this cowboy get up. I want you to see the background with George Washington above this cauldron here, just like the other one that belonged to Jebediah. And that wild, wild west, right? When we jump back to where it came up today already, with Jebediah Springfield, right? And all of this stuff for Obama gets headshot. Obama rise to power, Obama head wound, 878, which is Commerce Bank Arena, right? All of that, where Beyonce is going to be playing on 729. It's stunning. It's stunning. So notice for the silver tongue, Martin Luther King Jr., characteristics of a psychopath, the New Atlantis, reference to November 6th, which is a 66 reference. Notice the English and simple values are the same as the Misfits Bullet in Hollywood Babylon. It's actually a song that is also off of that EP. Again, reference to Martin Luther King, the G of Freemasonry. Remember, that is the seventh letter. All of the connections there. God of the Aquarius Age, subliminal messages, apocalyptic desires, and the blind leading the blind, which is all too often what we have to deal with. So now, with that, when you keep moving here, so Lisa, she's so stunned and shocked by this that she makes these posters that say wanted for treason, and she's going to put all of these up before the big bicentennial celebration of the founding of Springfield. So it's all incredibly important when we're looking at this, and you see that the phrase wanted for treason can actually not be wanted for crimes of treason, but wanted for acts of treason, as in to commit acts of treason. So notice when we're looking at it like that, and just typed in the same, you see four horsemen of the apocalypse. Wants to be hated and feared, I know all of Satan's lies, and set the world on fire. Now notice that the English and simple values are the same as Frankfurt, Germany. And now with everything that I was just stating emphatically about Commerce Bank Arena, you need to know that Frankfurt, Germany is where that arena is located. You see the Brotherhood seal, the United Nations, history repeats, corrupt justice, all things are revealed, end of the Antichrist, the second 9/11, weather modification in the Scottish Rite. All of these are appearing in the phrasing of wanted for treason, for these things. The number 1188 is exceptionally important. 11 plus 88 is obviously 99. And if we look at this number on its own here, I want you to see that when it's inverted, 891 days is the days between Kennedy's assassination and when the Church of Satan was founded. And so when you see that 891, you see Queen of Babylon, brother of the Freemasons, Lord of Destruction, I am the devil, unholy idols. All right, you see all of that coming into play here. Now, when we break this apart, wanted for treason, if I were to look at treason on its own, what do I get? Jewish values that are the same as formation, and Sade bring me home. 366, the number of days in a leap year. 2016 is a leap year with that many days in it. Look at Sade's Bring Me Home. Her name in red, this beam of light going home, ascending, everything I talked about in that immensely fascinating video. Alright, so again, all of this that I've talked about. Disappearing, bloodstain, book of beast, a satanic mark, the blood of man. Right, and again, tick, 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 all of that coming back to ticking time bomb. Notice the English and simple values are the same as Chan Hansen, where Prince was found dead, as well as hot sauce. Again, reference to formation directly. Reference to Leviathan, Demon King, Manhattan, Planet X, Nations, and the Dragon. Bizarrely, there is a dragon in this episode of The Simpsons, and I'll show you that when we get to it. So the next bit moving along here is this scene that Lisa sees, in which she discusses from the history books that she's read what she feels to be the events that truly took place in Trenton, New Jersey in the year 1781. And so as you saw, it was clearly hidden there. Now I'm going to talk about all this, but notice for Trenton, New Jersey, you have I have hidden everything in plain sight. Racial division in America is being funded by George Soros, something that there is evidence of, and the next one that calls me a sinner will be incinerated. You see, the English and simple values are the same as Yes, I Can, Sammy Davis Jr., which is a reference to the Don King, Donald Trump fight from Celebrity Deathmatch. Notice again the 138, the zero, the silence at the end of that there, connecting it in even one step further. But do notice 153 comes up again, written all the way out. What did I show you? In the right eye. Okay? All of those connections is very important. You see, dictated by authority, magnificent 888, all right? 153 gives you a reference to triple number, and here you see magnificent 888. You also see the appearance of the 11. So 1781, as I said earlier, has the same English and simple values as plate 107 and the mysterious T. Go back in the video if you don't remember already, and it is also worth noting that 1781 is 15 years before Stuart actually began painting the Athenaeum, which he started in 1796. Of course, 15 being the devil card, and remember everything I've been talking about with 15 years, because when I found out that Richard Greenough had made the statue of Ben Franklin that fell down when Erykah Badu was doing the performance of the song Dorothy Parker by Prince. It's talking about how that statue was made by presumably Richard Greenough, presumably Horatio Greenough's brother, the man who made the enthroned Washington, and that there were 15 years in between the debuts of those statues, and again comparing it to that card. And so again, here you see all these references to not fearing the 11, Path of the Hangman, Final Warning, so on. Alright, but all immensely fascinating. It's also worth noting that George Washington would have been 49 years old in 1781. So if we invert it, we get the number 94, which I have highlighted there. So it has to be something for you here. So do notice, yeah, absolutely. And I'll just pull it up in today's presentation since it'll have all of the pieces that we need. When we look into it, it'll be the same as Terror. Sasha Fierce, the code name for Beyonce, her MK Ultra Alter. You see Queen Bey, Mike Will, the producer for Formation, as well as Black Boxes and Obnoxio. Remember who I showed you everything that I'll be talking about with Mayor Hoag, who had been performing as a clown since the age of 15, just so we can stay in accordance with that number there. And so I had one other set written out for you here. Let me see if 143 is in this presentation. So yeah, it comes up when we're looking at Liberty Vance adding his names together, and that's the number of the day of the year that Sade's Bring Me Home was released. All right, so that again does immediately tie back to everything that I was talking about with Sade a moment ago, and we're going to get to Liberty Vance here because that is a huge bit, but not till later on. All right, so notice now, when we break down that year 1781 as 1781, you get the Mark of the Beast slash Antichrist death. You also see the Elite Web, Illuminatus Antichrist, and War in America. Now, the English and simple values here are the same as Celebrity Deathmatch and a Watch and Learn feature. Now, this is crazy because what do we see in this scene? A Celebrity Deathmatch between these two founding fathers going at each other, as well as a Watch and Learn feature, which I showed you in the beginning of this video. It is the propaganda film that the kids are watching. So again, look through all of that. And so I want to state that since we're seeing so many connections to Celebrity Deathmatch, it makes sense to look at it how they may appear on the show. So, on the show they'll typically break them down or do something and have a themed fight of some sort. So arguably one of the ways it could be broken is Washington, Springfield. Remember, they don't put verses. So when you put those two together, you get Illuminati Synagogue of Satan, Struggle Within, 666 Curse, Specializes in Evil and United Nations Organization. Does that sound familiar? I'm going to tie the UN to this so unbelievably tight here in a moment that it is stunning. Again, as always. But so notice the English and simple values down below, Novus Ordo Seclorum, New Order of the Ages. And what's that again? Written out there, 153, okay, again, just to pull it up for you in the right eye so you can just see it coming up. Look up top since it comes up so much, capital punishment, see the hour is near. Again, that's right down below there. You can look into all of that. This is all completely connected and referential towards itself, all right? Military dictatorship, the master manipulator, all right? The two founding fathers based on lies. Contaminated vaccinations, the revelation of tarot and the shape of the universe. So, after this fight, when Jebediah is walking away or running away, he tears off a piece of the painting on the floor of Washington, the Athenaeum, and that's what he later writes that letter on that Lisa read in the Historical Society. So now Lisa writes a paper on this, and Miss Hoover gives her an F. She gives her a 6. All right, it's immensely important to note that. But she goes on this whole tirade calling her a PC thug, this and that. But I want you to see that Lisa's paper was titled Jebediah Springfield, Fraud. And that is the same coding as Susanna Jones, who is the world's oldest woman who died at the age of 116 recently. And you do see coded with it White Horse, as well as Fool to Universe. Again, the whole span of the tarot, the whole span of the great work. You see Sadistic Will, the Base Master of Treachery, We Are the Gods, Music Industry, and United States Army. Now down below, the English and simple values are the same as Dorothy M. Johnson. Now this is beyond stunning, because we're going to look into, and remember a minute ago I was talking about Liberty Vance, but we're going to look more extensively at Dorothy M. Johnson, who is the author of this short story that the film was then based on. But notice here, Lisa's decision to hide the truth about Jebediah and preserve the myth is a reference to the man who shot Liberty Valance. In her paper, Jebediah Springfield Fraud is coded the same as the author of that book. All right. That should be enough. But that's point 24, which I will note at this point is crucial, because inverting and adding that mirror 24 is the 66, which is the number of points that I have in the PEZ theory. You see Death of the Antichrist, the Word of God made flesh, the knowledge of 11, reveal hidden truths, I am the light and the way, as well as the quantum number, which is actually in there a lot if you look into it. So now, Lisa is struck with so much contempt and grief for all of this that she gets the town all rallied up. And this is where I'm going to start to tie over into Zachary Taylor here. But she gets everybody all rallied up to go unearth Jebediah Springfield because she's so convinced that she is right. And this is much the same as what happened with Zachary Taylor, the 12th president of the U.S. All right, so just take a look at some of this stuff here. The cause of death, cholera morbus, is what it was having to do with. You see it's a form of gastroenteritis, right? Something having to do with the gastrointestinal tract, just like Anthony Kiedis when he was hospitalized on that day that I was telling you had to look out for. All right, so we're going to talk about this. Zachary Taylor, old rough and ready. All of those things, all right? So notice that his name is 13 letters. Important. The death card. The Jewish value is the same as nor let the fools mistake love. Remember, for there are love and the dove. Or excuse me, there are love and love. There's the dove and the serpent. All right? Incredibly important. Notice for Zachary Taylor, reference to the return to the void. The center of the universe, 11, 9, 11, which are the numbers that we would get when looking at the word kiss. Now, this is the 11th letter, the 9th, and S can both reduce to 1. And so you have that there. Now, hold that in your head as I go through here for a moment. You see reference to black man in the White House making money off of people's miseries, the protocols of the elders of Zion, destructive spirit, that the dead may rise up and inhale the incense, 1 through 36, which totals 666. And don't forget about 85, which could also be 58. So let's go over here. Let's start with that, with the 85, because it is the same as Plan 9, the label, right, that put out the Bullet EP. You see CBS News, the devil. Crucify, violence, hail Satan, falsehood, dead ringer. It's what they were going for with Kennedy, arguably the body of J.T. Tippett. And notice as well, if we look at it straight on, it's 58, it's the same as KISS. Immensely important, because as I showed you, it is right up top here. And remember that 2016, on July 29th, the same day that Beyonce is going to be playing Commerce Bank Arena, the same day that Erykah Badu's The Land comes out is the 58-year anniversary of NASA. It's a big fucking deal. The English in simple values here, again, notice with this 138, if we drop that silence, the zero there. All right, and that 173, do remember JPL initial reductions. Third World War. Agenda 21, demonic martial law, Master of Lodge, and 107, just like plate 107 for Jebediah Springfield's silver tongue. So take a look here, the cause of death for Zachary Taylor listed as cholera morbus, which is the same Jewish value as ice cream. This is a Marvel character that we're going to be looking at later on here who appeared in one issue of X-Men, the one featuring Obnoxio the Clown. So if I pull up ice cream here for you, just so you can catch a glimpse of that, you see murder addiction and the rose eaters. Okay, very important. The English in simple values are the same as inauguration, which is again something that we will look at shortly here, but do notice you see reference to infernal bloodlust, soul contract, an image in honor of the beast, and the aeon of Babylon and the beast. Also see reference to Babylon is genocide. Notice as well the breakdown for the word inauguration. It's 12 letters. Zachary Taylor was the 12th president. All of that, the way it breaks down to the master thelemic number. But so let's go back here now so we can keep talking about this. Notice as well Zachary Taylor was exhumed in Louisville, Kentucky on June 17th, 1991. So it was the 168th day of that year because the reason I want to mention that to you is because it is the same simple value as Beyonce Knowles. And so let's get that to pop up for you there so you can take a look at that. And so you have very clearly written out for you, European Union, Devil in Disguise, Sweet 16, Evil Intention, the law fulfilled. Okay, remember, Beyonce Knowles is how her name appears in the Celebrity Deathmatch episode, okay? From that day, there are 197 days remaining in the year. That is the same simple value as George Dr. Death Nichols, who, as we'll talk about more extensively here, is performing the actual autopsy on Zachary Taylor's body. So give me just a second here if I can just pull this up so I can show you. And it was right in front of me there. But so you can see, that's the medical examiner for this. I don't want there to be any loose ends, loose hairs, anything like that. But so do notice, though, if I want to pull that up and show you those values, well, I guess I have to show you Dr. Death, not D-Death. Jeez. Really stole me out there, huh? That's clever. So do notice, though, that that Jewish value is the same as cherry. And I'm going to talk about this later, but of all the things Price Economics could have chose, they put Zachary Taylor in front of a background of cherries. And I want you to see that that coding is also the same as as Erica Badu, Love Gun, and Fifth Avenue, Bite the Bullet, Beast of the Sea, Babylon Liberator. But excuse me, because 197 is what we're looking at. You see, there is no coincidence. The future of Earth, seven trumpets, and volcanic eruption. All right, so now let's go back. All of that. And so again, noting that that 197 is the same Jewish value as Prince is definitely worth noting, since I've shown you so much, and I guess that's all I've really got for Prince, but with his connections to this. But so the word exhumed has a Jewish value of 552. That has a value of Obama gets headshot, idols of Lucifer, remnant of people, and the CERN portal. Now, this is also the length of Prince's song, When Doves Cry, which was his number one song, and it's what I looked into extensively when I did my video on Prince talking about that whole mess, okay? So go back and watch that and see how all those connections there are really fascinating. So I want to note that Zachary Taylor died on July 9th, 1850, but he wasn't buried until November 1st. That's a triple one. You reduce this all the way down, the year is five. You get that triple five. Which, do remember, it's absolutely the same for Purple Rain. All right, just so you can see time and time and time again how these things come up. All right, the significance. 116 days later is another way of looking at that time and space in there. So now, probably wondering where I'm getting that from. And so we'll pull back here and just show you a page real quick. I think it's on this one. You can see it's talking extensively about the details of his remains being handled, where he's buried, all of that stuff. Of course, that place is now a national landmark. So, keep going here. To be fair, his remains were held at Congressional Cemetery from July 13th to October 25th, or 105 days. So, just to keep it moving for you, the visual album for Beyoncé's Lemonade is 105. It's 1 hour, 5 minutes. You do see for that 105 coding, 9/11. Messenger, sudden death, the world, suffering, masonry, cliffoth, symbols, and vitriol. Remember, that is alchemical model hidden on the 14th card of the tarot deck, the art card, meaning to visit the interior of the earth, guided by true will. Now, talked a lot about that in the past, so I don't want to expand too much on it here. Because this video, all in its entirety, is going to be well into 2.5 hours at least. I'll probably parse it out in about an hour-long block each. But you have to watch it all together. Now, notice that it is weird how they took him out for 7 days before recommitting him to the ground. Okay. July 9th to the or excuse me, October 25th to November 1st is 7 days, and that he was out for 4 days after his death, the 9th to the 13th, when he was put in the congressional cemetery. That's 11 days. These are two divinely important numbers with the occult. You get the 77 when you multiply them. It's 11 days total, though, that he's out of the ground. Now, this is really weird to me because with all these connections to the celebrity death match with Don King versus Donald Trump in this episode, it's very interesting to note that Muhammad Ali, who Don King was the manager of, was buried in Louisville, Kentucky as well. Now, I just think that's crazy because of all of these connections I've shown you. And that the video that I did talking about those connections with Don King, Donald Trump, celebrity deathmatch, and all of that was banned. Alright, that's very interesting to me. And that leads right into the next point here, where we're looking at the full-out coding of President Zachary Taylor. And you see the phrase, U.S. died June 11th. Same day, the wait is over, all of that coding I showed you at the beginning of this video. Erykah Badu and Ricky Smiley were playing that show together. The 888 coding of Verizon Arena, so on, so forth. Alright, this is something I talked about so much, I just need to go on it here. But so, let's take a look at Gilbert Stuart here. This is the man who was doing the actual painting that we refer to as the Athenaeum, however you pronounce that. Started in 1796, though, but notice, just like Zachary Taylor, he has 13 letters in his first and last name as well, and he also died on July 9th, 22 years before Zachary Taylor died. Again, that number 22. Now notice his Jewish value is the same as the Misfits' bullet. You see, go forth and conquer, study, movie, in your face. Now, for study, movie, Misfits, Bullet, just talking about the video of mine that was banned. Remember, Parkland Memorial Hospital is all 8-letter words. And when I was talking about it, just, and please pause and look through the coding for this, because this is absolutely one of the most stunning bits here. And I don't have it written out because it was something that I was doing in more of a live spirit, but this hospital is located at 5201 when Kennedy was taken there, but the address is currently 5200, whatever the street is. Now, it was changed to 5201 for a handful of years, and when you invert the number 5201, it is the number 1025, which is, now get this, the number of days before the Kennedy assassination that a movie that Marilyn Monroe was in titled The Misfits was released. You drop that zero out of there, I'll take you one step further. That movie is 1 hour and 25 minutes long, or excuse me, 125 minutes long. What do you think about that? Look at the inversion of the 125, the 521, the Path of Resh and Black Operations. Illuminati has caused many people to have heart attacks. I'm going to talk about that with Adlai Stevenson here in just a minute, former U.S. ambassador to the United Nations. But so since notice there that Plan 9 Records comes up again, and is directly tied with the Misfits bullet over on the left side of your screen here, and you look through all of that, because it said it's the same simple value. There's the 125, John Kennedy, dark deception, hypnosis, just like the pendulum in the Nestle Nescafe commercial, NN55, that played after Cronkite told us that he was assassinated. Look at the Plan 9 Jewish, Great Lightning, Lone Gunman, Bunch of Lies, 1 hour. You know, if you go back through and actually watch when Cronkite was saying that, he says that the president was shot about 1 hour and 38 minutes ago, just like we are 138. And you type that in, you get this repeating 666 gold egg of the Aeon of Matt. This is absolutely stunning. You put that next to studying the movie, you see what the fuck I'm talking about. Check it out. It's the epitome of arrogance, because it's all there. Not me. God, no. It's taking everything in me not to say I told you so about June 11th. Alright, and I'm not going to. I will make a whole other video on it. But notice here as well, the last Trump, message from God in October, grandiose delusions, and seers are Illuminati. Now down below for Gilbert Stuart, the English and simples are the same as Sebastian Murdoch, Donald Sutherland, remember playing the voice of Hollis Hurlbut in this episode, as well as Agent X or X in JFK. And you also see it's the same as Old Rough and Ready, which was the nickname for President Zachary Taylor. And Sebastian Murdoch, for those of you who are doubtlessly wondering about who that is the author for the article from the Huffington Post that I was examining about Donald Trump saying he'd be able to shoot somebody and not lose any voters over it. So you see that direct connection with Bullet there, okay? Absolutely critical. Here's your 27. Here's your 888. Fire and brimstone, all right? So for Donald Sutherland here, just see these ideas of secret donations. That is, English and simple values are the same as Gilbert Stuart, Sebastian Murdoch, and Old Rough and Ready. All right, absolutely tied in there. Take a look at this painting here, the Athenaeum. You see an idol of Lucifer. Mr. President. And I want to remind you, since I took a look at this happy birthday Mr. President bit, and since I just showed you that stunning connection with the Misfits and Bullet and Marilyn Monroe, happy birthday Mr. President. Check this out here, Rider on the White Horse, down below 666, Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn, having been drugged and disoriented, the wonderful Wizard of Oz, in the phrase abandon hope, all ye who enter here. This is all with the phrase exposing the satanic lullaby. Goddamn right. Alright, so, back to the left. Queen of the Dead, intent to kill, false doctrines, a great architect, dragon of chaos. Remember, I'm going to come back to that. English and simple values. I've said this several times in the video now. This is a keystone number in here. Alright, it should be noted that again, since there are 66 points in this, I want to point out that when we look at the written out form of 66 here, when it comes up in all of this coding, let me see if I can get one that has all of it put in for you. All right, I want you to see that since it's the 29 point in a 66 point bit, that 29 coming up in there and this idea of skull and bones is absolutely paramount to it. All right, blood sacrifice, Don Trump, divine star, top secret, again. See this coding for Athenaeum on its own here. Now, let's get into Adlai Stevenson a bit. So, back to our Lisa the Iconoclast. When the people of Springfield are going to dig up the bones of Jebediah, they cover up the flame on Adlai Stevenson's grave. Now, for those of you not familiar with who Adlai is here, I've got somewhere for you in this one over here. I've got for you this screenshot here so you can see this is absolutely who they're referring to. And so you can see he was born February 5th, 1900 and died July 14th, 1965, aged 65. It's important to note that Zachary Taylor was also 65. Notice that he was the 31st governor of Illinois. 31 is the number of the Book of the Laws, a hidden bit of coding there that you learn from familiarizing with the adjustment card and the Book of Law itself. I want you to see quite a bit. But I want you to see his connection with the phrase spiderweb. I want you to see the Jewish coding 1155, 11 and 55 as 66. I want you to see again 153 written out here again, and all the times that I have shown you that coming up in this phrase, in the right eye. I want you to know for all of those redundancies in the right eye that I keep saying throughout this, that the baseline of this theory having to go back to this Simpsons intro being one of the biggest pieces of predictive programming ever, involving ice cream going into the right eye of the idol of Lucifer on Ralph's head, is absolutely monumentally powerful. All right? Absolutely powerful. And so take a look back here. You see the new Barak. See, will be done. You are the master. Supremacist groups, wait and see, and war in America. Now notice the English and simple values down below are the same as Commerce Bank Arena. Again, Shooter's Hill, where the George Washington Masonic National Museum is located. All right, and the world's oldest woman who died at 116. Subconscious, messages revealed, satanic rulers, Obama damaged right eye, Luciferian Mason, and mystical arts. All right, so here you have, I talk more about Adlai, his middle name. You can look at him more. But again, these connections to the United Nations and him being the ambassador to the UN, the fifth U.S. ambassador. And he was absolutely in there during JFK and John Kennedy's presidencies. So he died in 1965, which was 115 years after Zachary Taylor's death. As I stated just a moment ago there, they were both 65 when they died. So now, we go to this scene here. And you know what, at the 2-hour break, give me just 1 second here to go and grab something to drink. My drink is empty here. One moment. All right, so again, we're at the gravesite. We're unearthing Jebediah Springfield. You have these members of the town gathered around here, all very important. Chief Wiggum removes the head, shows that there's no silver tongue. Notice the full moon behind him here. Let's go back. When he's holding the head and singing there, he's singing Camp Town Ladies. All right, and I talked about this earlier on, and you'll notice here these respected members of the community, the Reverend, the Doctor, and the Mayor, as well as Homer, who absolutely has some of the most profound connotations and coding of any character. But they all couldn't be having a better time watching the use of the founder of their town be used in a mocking way, singing this song, Camp Town Ladies. So again here, notice for Camp Town Ladies, it's the double 13 coding, the appearance of 11, child snuff film community, 153 fish, remember 153, it's still pulled up on the other side for you. Fish, the coding with none, the death card, things I talked about in what will probably be part one of this video after I parse it out. Notice down below the English in simple values, the Great Babylon, the Great Deceiver, the Path to Quoth, that's the moon. Remember everything I've talked about with the number 18. You see erotic violence, head mind control, and delights in evil. So it's important to note it that Chief Wiggum is the one who, right, as I say, pulls the corpse out there. And you see reference to Justice for All, the Golden Dawn, Secret Satanic Sorority, Gematria of 33, the New Blood, commits murder then suicide, as well as Creator beheads Zeus. His English and simple values are the same as Iconoclast, Formation, Saves the Bee, and TMZ staff. Again, Mark of Beast, Image of Satan, Knighthood. Clancy Wiggum is another way that he is commonly referred to as on the show. So notice here, both his names in that are six letters, giving us a nice 66. The Jewish value is the same as Beyonce Knowles and Erica Abby Wright's, Erica Badu's full name spelled out there. You see reference to MK Ultra mind control as well as, and ritual abuse, all one phrase, Babylon mystery, moon civilization, on and on. Notice the English and simple values here are the same as Donald Trump, Beyonce Lemonade, Sade Bring Me Home, The Brothers, Cat Williams, The Teflon Don, A Real Cup of Coffee, that's from Nestle Nescafe commercial, and Masturbate Me. It's from the song Bullet from the Misfits. It's when he's talking about sodomizing Jackie O. And you see how it's all connected right in that bit, the one unearthing. All right, and that Chief Wiggum gives you the whole bit there. Master Mason, behind the 11, number 7, God bless Satan, great architect, 911 call, I hear horsemen, remember they were looking for people for treason, looks can fool and long overdue. So Clara Rising, again if we go back to this article about him, so of course just her name being Rising is auspicious in and of itself. It's a six-letter word. 18 reduces down to 9. So 9 and 6 is 15, the devil card. 1 and 5, 6, the lover's card, the great work. You can also look at that as the 18th card. You know what? No, I'm not even going to go into that one because it's too much, too much. But so notice that Rising is the one who is responsible for wanting his body to be exhumed. You see here on June 17th, the day of all of that, she's the one wheeling the crip out by there with everybody, absolutely connected. Notice image of Satan, skull the highest, English and simple values, same as Chief Wiggum, formation, save the bees and TMZ staff. Remember that Save the Bees linking back to Erykah Badu's most recent cover from her EP, She Can't Use My Phone. She looks like Shiva, it's Control Freak, all of those things I've talked about, all right? So now take a look here. George, Dr. Death Nichols. Again, as I noted earlier on in this video, it's the same coding as Cherry, which is so bizarre to me. Because that's what's behind them. This is from Price Economics. I don't want to hear shit about how it's not a good source, or how it's one that would somehow be going to make that kind of argument. But you see, Bit the Bullet is dangerous. Death and Decay. Preparations is not innocent. The Babylon Liberator. Occultation, Satanic Abomination, and Distractions. Down below you do see, same as I know the pieces fit. CERN Super Collider, Man of Lawlessness, Seven Trumpets, Volcanic Eruption, all the things I've shown you with the code 1440, Volcanic Eruption, 411 Elm Street. There's really no into it. There's absolutely no into it. Alright. And so let's get back here to our Iconoclast clips. Lisa has a dream, because she's trying to let it all go. She's not really able to do so. She has this thing where Washington comes in and tells her she has to keep fighting the good fight. And when she does, she finds out that the tongue actually was there and that Hurlbut actually hit it. The character who's played by Donald Sutherland, he grabbed it before the dust could settle and hit it in that Wild Wild West scene that I showed you earlier. And she then finds out that it's on the back of the Athenium that the note from Jebediah Springfield proclaiming his evil background is found. And she completes the puzzle again, the cauldron below him there. But so, in going back, she puts all of that together. But she tells herself that she can't quite come to telling the town about it, that there is something more to it, and that the myth is more important. And this comes back to what I was referencing somewhere probably an hour or two ago, to the man who shot Liberty Valance and Dorothy M. Johnson, excuse me. But I want to show this quote here. It says, "Let him march, boys," because this is what Police Chief Wiggum says at the end, when Homer is marching through town and he takes the bell from Ned Flanders and it's like a breaks the law. and he endorses it. And so you see there, damage Obama's right eye, kissed by a rose. I'm sorry, Barack, crusher of crocodiles. The esoteric significance of that is beyond what I'm able to put forward to you. But notice as well, it's the same as Jonathon Collier, the PEZ Theory, Sunset Sound, and Police Chief Wiggum. All right, which I have for you right down below here. And again, all of these things with the number 7, the great architect, Obama executioner, just wait and see, order of the rose, hit the bullseye. All right, for Police Chief Wiggum, you see this 1331, the mirror of 13, just like for Camp Town races is 1313. It's very important how all of this fits. Police Chief Wiggum is the destruction of the human race, the source of evil, newspapers, the human extinction secret, stop the struggle of the poor, that's the Earth Institute at Columbia University, that's what they propose they do, but we know that that's not what they're using those resources for. You see, blaming others so they feed on blood, that's keeping us distracted and at each other's throats, divided and conquered, arguing over arbitrary things. You see, the moon god is the god of the Old Testament, hidden truth and lies exposed, as well as the art of war. The other phrase, the other part of when he says, let him march, boys, is let the man march. You see, Lucifer slash Hades, dark moon slash Lilith, no doubt connections. The phrase king and queen, Satanist, change is in order, sacrifice of children and the demon of anger. Now, I want you to know that I think when it says these things, such as sacrifices children, child snuff film, community organizer, all of those things with the snuff and children, I don't think it only pertains to children. I think they're absolutely incorporated in it. But if you read the Book of the Law, and even if you read really any religious text, I guess for that matter, refers to everybody as children. Adults are children. But in the Book of the Law, more specifically, it says we're children and how naive, ignorant, egotistical, narrow-minded, and all sorts of other things that are completely accurate of the mainstream consciousness, but how that makes us children. And so when you see sacrifice of children, that's who it's talking about, I think. Notice the English and simples for this are the same as on the ground, Charles Dickens' last words. Things that have come up immensely through today. Remember, 141 is the number of days in between when Don Trump said he could shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue in June 11th of this year when Ricky Smiling Body played that show. Will of Thelema, Age of Aquarius, Tribulation, Hairbringer of Death, a Devourer, Underground, hit the target. When you put the whole phrase together, you see, let him march, boys, let the man march. You get reference to the same Jewish coding as the mysterious T. It's the episode that Beyonce and Missy Elliott fought each other on Celebrity Deathmatch, the one in which John Edwards' decapitated head, remember his coding is the same as Antichrist, and a number of other things that we baseline throughout here, as well as Athenium and Cromulent. But that his corpse is the one that writes, beware the T. T is the 20th letter. It's the Aeon card. Notice here for the coding, you see inverted pentagram, Dorothy mourning a death, as well as senseless violence. Barack Obama is the demon joker. The English simple values down at the bottom, you find deep in military preparations, family of the great tribulation, as well as beyond the observable universe. What exactly does terror mean, and welcome to the Twilight Zone? I want you to see that the English value here, this 1872, is the same Jewish value as the mystery box of fun. So do remember that the mystery box of fun was in the Mysterious T episode. Alright, and its coding is the same as Parkwood Entertainment, which is who released the Formation single. And I think I have it written for you somewhere up here. If not, I'm just going to tell you Mystery Box of Fun. Yep, there it is. is 15 letters, and if you reduce it, see here, 4, 2, that adds together is 6, because O and F both reduce to 6, so you have a triple 6. All right, the mystery box of fun directly ties to that. Even when you look at the English value, 15 and 66 are next to each other. The devil card in this hugely important skull and bones number. 1 and 5 is 6, giving us another one there. All right, again, the United States of America. All right, but up top, when we're looking at this for the 1872, you see Phoenix, symbol of resurrection, as well as I Love You Illuminati, church and government denominations, a man that was killed by the FBI, and what is CERN really doing? All powerful concepts. Notice down here for these English and symbols, the family of the Great Tribulation. I just want to reiterate that again, because in a block of the phrase, let the man march, you see reference to tribulation, as well as Will of Thelema. Remember, with all these concepts, the number 8, holy significance, this and that. It's the 8th tarot card, is adjustment, formerly justice, which is not a concept that is something that exists in nature. It's an arbitrary, subjective term. There's only adjustment to what survives. All right, but looking back to this phrase, the full phrase there, in the English and simple values, you do have, what exactly does terror mean? And so that is how I'm going to springboard into the last bit of this, but I am going to ask that you give me just one moment here, and if you notice any cuts in this when I upload them, as far as the time, it is simply for me having to go and just edit this out later if when I step up for a moment here, it's longer than I anticipate, all right? So please give me one moment. All right. Thank you for bearing with me for just a second there. I am doing this entire video in one straight shot here, and looking at my clock, we're about 2.25 hours in here, so I had to just get up and move for a second, because that is a long time to be sitting down. But this is utterly important, and I have to get this done for you. So, jumping back in here, the last thing we were talking about, let him march, boys, let the man march, gives us the phrase, what exactly does terror mean? Now, I want to show you If we look up the word terror, you do get reference to Neron Caesar, the man who burned down Rome, allegedly as a part to kill Christianity. And so Rome allegedly burned for 9 days, and he is held in a lot of stories to be representative of the Antichrist and to have risen from the dead. Do also notice you see reference to Roman Catholic Obama the Beast, Operation, the Satanic Bible, Idol of Baphomet, the Horned One, Particle of God, and Toth 8. Again, right before I went on the break there, I did actually go into a bit of a tangent there about the 8th tarot card, so very important. Now, do notice down below the English and simple values for terror are the same as Sasha Fierce, Queen Bey, Mike Will, Black Boxes, and Obnoxio. So I covered all of those earlier. But what I do want to reiterate something on is that 564 is the same Jewish value as groupthink. And so this is very critical to pull aside here. So as you can see, both five-letter words, the 55, we could get the 72 or the 9 through that when we break down the coding. But geez, it's such a popular one. So there for Jewish for 564, here you have Don Trump. Tarot Gematria, the number 9, as I just stated, you can see in it there. You also see Sacred Ground, the Angels of Satan, the Fear Hoax, and the Scheme of Things, all right? So, and of course, Groupthink has the same English and simple coding as Dallas Love Field, which is where Kennedy was heading from when he was assassinated, all right? And you do see coming up in there, Freemasonry, this and that. You know what? I've actually got 834 in this one over here. If you want to take a look, it is going to come up at the end here. So absolutely critical to pull up there. But you do see Freemasonry, an eye for an eye, punishment, I am the Dark Lord, Imperial Cult, God is the Devil, right? 69, all these numbers that I've been looking into. And so let's keep moving here, though, because now let's start tying back more into a little bit about Pez. And so something that you need to see here is that it was founded in 1927 by a man named Edward Haas III. And so, again, tying back, because I'm sure this is on another video now, do remember the 44 brick-like candies. And it wasn't until the year 1955 that the Pez company started to put characters on the Pez dispensers, such as Santa Claus and Mickey Mouse. And remember, 1955 is the same year that Representative Pete Sessions, let me pull him up for you here, was born. He was born on March 22nd, 1955. So you see why I wanted to show you that there, the 322 and the 55. But you do see Law of Thelema, Water Bearer, Blood Shower, Source of All Evil, okay, the Smithsonian Museum, the 36 triangular number, all of these things, as well as Divine Comedy and the Voice of Lucifer. Now, what I want you to see, though, aside from all of that interesting stuff of just when they're together, I want you to see that Edward Haas III has, for a Jewish value, the same coding as Susan in Pasadena, California. So do remember for Erykah Badu's official fan site here, Susan is absolutely the one, the only person that puts posts on here. The coding for Susan is 444 for the English and simple values if you look it up. So that's very critical to keep in mind as well, as the fact that Susan is an anagram for as sun, okay? Something that I think is definitely important to keep in mind. You notice as well that Don King happens to have those 444 English and simples as well. References to occult, killing, Barak death, the king, so on and so forth, okay? So notice the English and simple values for Edward Haas III here are the same as David X. Cohen. It's the one who made up the word cromulent, which we've talked about throughout here. It's the same as Rose Bowl, which is where Beyonce played. On May 14th in Pasadena, California. All right, just so we can be sure that this all ties together here. And again, Pasadena, California, the Jet Propulsion Laboratory location, everything I showed you there. You also see Bring Me Home, this is Sade reference, join the ESD, the Earth Space Defense reference. All right, you see reference to child sacrifice, again, everything I told you about people who do not appreciate the world, children who feed into distraction, children, You see Death's Door, Necessary, and French Horn. And of course, all of this tying back in ample ways to the Formation music video here. And again, the More Than a Dreamer, Martin Luther King, everything we've talked about with that, the French horns next to the phrase, the truth. All right, all this stuff we've been talking about, Sade's Bring Me Home. This is from the Sweetest Taboo music video I looked into. But do notice, just bizarrely, she writes fear in Spanish at the end. All of these instances with her guitar player having these bull horns behind him. The FF on his guitar, it's a 6-6. Her fenders, her getting the gun here, right? All of the bizarre stuff. Remember all the coding for Love Gun that we've seen as well, since it makes sense to see Sweetest Taboo, Love Gun, Badu, Fifth Avenue, all these things I've shown you together here. The 11 women on this cover, the Lust card represented, the four members of KISS, the Emperor card, government, law, limitation, all of that. All right. You could look at these pillars as a number of things, as a portal. You could look at them as an 11. You could look at the sun behind them as the zero, the silence, the joining of everything back to the perfect state of nothingness. You could also look at it as a reference to sun worship. However you look at it, you have to understand that it is immensely important in connection with all of this information. All right, so now let's get back here. And notice in the back of this intro for The Simpsons with the right eye, the ice cream, the beheading, the Pez, everything we talked about. In the background is the restaurant Zesty's Pizza and Subs. And this is supremely important because this intro was made well after this episode. This is season 7 that we're in. And the new intro there didn't come about till season 20, the Aeon. Go figure. But follow me back here to Lisa the Iconoclast. And when she's giving this speech here, when she's about to reveal to the town the truth about Jebediah Springfield and that everything is born on a lie and completely violate their just world theory, essentially send them into anarchy. Remember, that's the whole, even if you go back to Lisa the Iconoclast, just the title of this episode, you have Anarchy King, Causing Despair, the Three Threes, right? All of these things, the powers that be, secrets kept hidden, dial M for murder. I want you to see, and when we come back, there's a shooter for a split second aiming down at her. And what do you see in season 7? That is still here for what I've been talking about is directly connected with someone being shot. Zesty's. It appears as Zesty's pages. All right, secret satanic sorority, Obama beast of revelation, nuclear warhead, the beast of war in United States, last president. Notice the reductions here. You can get it down to 66. Notice, like I said, that this video and the Pez theory are divinely inspired. 42 mirrored and added, and just like I stopped on 24 to reiterate, it's 66. The English and simple values here are the same as thief in the night. This is the fool. This is the one who goes on to conquer the universe. You see the Holy Ghost, sun worship, occultic master, an ideology of hate, the destroyer, an alchemical process. Solvet coagula. You see thy kingdom come, our fleabag gunmen. And I think that's a direct reference to the shooter in Dealey Plaza that was down in the gutters that arguably is the one who delivered the kill shot on Kennedy. Alright, and again, because Zesty's Pages is absolutely coming from a scene very similar to Kennedy being in the crosshairs. I mean, this is nuts. Evil handlers, WWE, WEE, it's 555. It's crucial. Now, Zesties on its own gives us the numbers 584. Those are the numbers for On the Ground. The last words of Charles Dickens, who's come up immensely, whose eighth book, David Copperfield, it's so tied in with all of this, it's sickening. Okay. Luciferian Mason, the King of the Snakes, the Doctrine of Lies. Down below, Will of Thelema, Age of Aquarius, on and on and on. The English and simple values are the same as the Tower, Friends Arena, and Rose City. Rose City is another name for Portland, Oregon. Place of immense importance to the occult. Roses, of course, the Rosicrucians. You see Holocaust, history, the founding of the U.S. state in Roman numerals, New World, World War, Evil Curse, Keystone, 19th, and Secret Areas. Now, remember earlier in this video for the word cromulent, and again, all of the things that it shares the coding with that connect all of this. But one of the things it said was anagrams and gematria. And so I wanted to pull that phrase into the light for you just a little bit. So let's go back. I'm getting way ahead of myself. Yeah, we still got a way to go. We're talking 4-hour video here, people. But so an anagram for Zesty's pages is spy sets gaze. What does that look like he's doing? And another anagram for that is PEZ stage SS, or SS PEZ stage. Which if you type in is PEZ stage 11, because S and S reduced to 11, the English and simple values for it are the same as Zesty's pages. All of this right here. This is wildly important for you, and this is why I looked into the PEZ. Because of the PEZ stage and the SS and all of those connections, and to see that PEZ stage 11 is the same as SS. So when you look into the coding for PEZ, what do you think you see? Notice what number it is. Alright, just like the original logo is made out of 44 pieces of PEZ candy. You see Rosicrucian, the Secret Path, Spirit of Moloch, Cult Members, the Great Old Ones, the CERN Time Loop, and Hidden Opponents. The English and simple values, Beast, Time, Babylon, France, F, the sixth letter, it's a six-letter word, it's another double six. You see Omen and Zika. You also see Babylon. So notice down below, and this is going to segue us into talking about the man who shot Liberty Valance. But Lisa does not tell everybody. And remember all the times I was talking about a dragon. And in this scene where he's asking her why he didn't say anything, a dragon goes by. And so I want you to see for the myth of Jebediah, you have reference to the crowned snake. And she says the myth of Jebediah is more important than what she has to say. And you see Aquarius Apocalypse, the human will. That is, people will believe what they want. Psychotic child murderers, July plan. That lines up with a lot of my 729. Pale White Horse, the Obama Synagogue of Satan, loss of civil rights, scalar weapons. Remember, that is absolutely what HAARP is, and the implications of those sort of weapons really is endless. It is everything from being able to cause what would otherwise be referred to as natural disasters to literally making it sound as if we are hearing things, voices. You see reference to things are not as they appear. The devil is in the details, the number 1 to 36, again the 666, the evil of the Cliffoth, in 1963, the year that Kennedy was assassinated. Now notice here as well, you see the Alpha and Omega, angels in the flesh, bury the hatchet, economic downfall, legend of Atlantis, Ellen in 9/11, the numbers 177. Now go through and be sure to look through all of that different coding there, because it is really quite endless at how those numbers can be properly applied to all of this. Now, let's take a look at the man who shot Liberty Valance. And as I stated somewhere in probably the first hour of this video, when she decides to preserve the myth of Jebediah, it is cited as being a direct reference to that story. And now you're really going to have to go back and watch all of this video to see all of the pieces in here, because I've been talking about them interchangeably throughout. But so the man who shot Liberty Valance, let me pull this back up for you here. Take a look here. This is the actual movie for it. It's a 1953 short story by Dorothy M. Johnson. The movie is 123 minutes long, all right? And so here's this bit here talking about the decision there, and we'll get into that. But I want to show you that 123 length loops us back to the date of January 23rd when Trump said he could shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue and get away with it, and inverting that number, giving us the 444. Now, Dorothy M. Johnson, do notice that 1600, that 16 in her coding there, the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry, followers of Lucifer. Austin Lee Meredith is the second coming of Christ, the Holy Dove Goddess, the key to the mysteries, and it was meant to happen. Again, the English and simple values are the same as Jebediah Springfield fraud, which is the paper that Lisa writes on Jebediah being a fraud and what she gets in trouble for and what leads to them unearthing his corpse. You see death of the Antichrist, the knowledge of 11 reveal hidden truths, and I am the light and the way. And then Dorothy comes up so very often. It's Dorothy Parker, Dorothy Johnson, Dorothy whatever the hell in Wizard of Oz. I wanted to take a look at it. I don't have this pulled up for you, but the Jewish value, when you type it in and you're looking at the page, the first crack in the dam comes up countless times. Notice as well here that the English and simple values are the same as days later. And Rick Rubin. Rick Rubin was the producer for the Red Hot Chili Peppers' latest album that will be coming out on what was originally slated for the 24th of this month. All the coding I looked into for that. But do notice that 635 is the same Jewish value as Shooter's Hill and TMZ. Again, we have these references to 9/11, Zionism, sudden death, Lightbringer, Masonry, and Vitriol. And so I want to loop back a little bit here, because we talked a lot about moons in the past, and videos of mine that were banned talked extensively about lunar cycles, so I think it's really important to mention this one. And I want you to see that for the month of July, since that's the month kind of we're talking about the most here, the full buck moon, every word is four letters, so it gives us this nice 444. So look at the Jewish value here. It's the same as Trauma Room 1. Now remember, this is the trauma room that Kennedy was pronounced dead in. You see here reference to triple number, the math of Lucifer, true proof, Babylonian king, the spirit of hate, and Earth's ionosphere. It has to do with H-A-A-R-P. Now, look down below with this English and simple value. It's the same as 777. It's also the same as Order of Thelema, Structure, Worship Hell, Life is But a Dream, and He is in the Hoax. Now, I want to show you that 444, all on its lonesome there, if we bring out the full coding for it, the Jewish value is absolutely Order of Thelema. And it's also head mind control, dualisms, and FEMA camp program. Alright, the English and simple values, Jesus, Lucifer, occult, killing, the king, anti-peace, war pig, all in there. Alright, and so really the extent that this number comes up is something that I can't overstate. Even if you look up 777, which has the same coding as Full Buck Moon, which has the three four-letter words, 777, look at that. 1114 gives you that 444. Again, directly connected with the order of Thelema. And so I just want to show you, if we add those numbers together, 444 and 777, because they are incredibly important numbers, that absolutely gives us Kiss Love Gun. Tower of Babel, Baal Worship, the Man of War, Reoccurring Possessions, the Voice of the Silence, Leaving the Age of Pisces, Babylon Mystery and Followers. Down below, the Antichrist, Queen of Babylon, Lord of the Flies, the Law of Thelema, as well as America, the Babylon, and Satanic Truth. Stunning. So you take a look here at when that moon is due to take place, and it's 6:57 p.m., which we can reduce down to 6:12, 5 and 7, 12. 6:12 is the same coding as Michael Pierce. It's also the same as Gravity, Jeff Martin, and A Real Cup of Coffee. But Michael Pierce is the guy who wrote the episode of The Simpsons, E Pluribus Wiggum, in which Ralph becomes elected mayor of Springfield. So you notice here for E Pluribus Ralph Wiggum, you do see 33rd degree Mason, as well as 2016 and the death of humanity next to ancestor worship. Michael Price, when we're looking into his coding, do notice that his Jewish value is the same simple value as Beyonce Knowles Carter, Enthroned Washington, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, and MK Ultra Mind Control. You see directly tied in here down below ideas of New Balance V, Murderer, Lie After Lie, 1011 and 1110 next to Lone Wolf and 111. Really, I cannot overstate this. If you want to see the 1110, look back to Lisa the Iconoclast. See how it fits in there. It's the same as 9 Years War, all these other things. MTV animation. If you look at it as the 1011, it's the same as Save the Bees. The underground bases, nuclear dissolution, God is the devil, seed of the devil. All of those things. So thoroughly connected for you. I have a hard time standing it. Alright. Jumping back to Michael Price. I want you to see ice cream here. I don't know if I have it written somewhere else, but since that's what goes into Ralph's eyes, it's coded the same as Abrahadabra and Rose. Abrahadabra is the word of the Aeon, signifying the completion of the great work. So now Liberty Valance here, when we take a look through this, I want you to see that both names are seven letters, and again, that's our incredibly important 77, and again, that goes all the way back to the beginning here with the reductions and all the things I've shown you with that 121. Now notice LV, his initials, 322, a skull and bones number, 3 times 22 for 66. If we add the 77 from the number of letters in his name with the 66 from his initial reductions, we get the number 143. And that must be something because I have it written out for you there. And so again, as you can see, I guess I do have it, just it's right next door here. It was the date of 5/22/2012, which is the day Sade's Bring Me Home was released. So again, immensely important and very intimately tied to all of this. Take a look down below. The English and simple values the same as Dallas Trademark, Pasadena, California, David Copperfield, God of All Things, and GB33ZB. Now, been tying Rick Ross into all of this and the Window Seat Remix video, and again telling you that video starts with him going and picking her up. She's been reincarnated after she was shot in Dealey Plaza in the Window Seat video. He goes and picks her up in front of this address, 330. It says jail release above there. That's important. But this is the license plate at the end. They get out of the car. They leave the car. The last thing you hear are gunshots. GB33ZB, Liberty Valance, a man who shot. Skull and Bones, The Meaning of Life, 29, 25, 66, 997. Again, I looked at this for you a while ago. I broke it down for you. So where we got this phrase, what was under Benjamin Franklin's home at 36 Craven Street? Okay. Remember, it was skeletons from at least 15 people. And I looked into that in an article from the Smithsonian. On and on and on. The Path of Resh. So Liberty Valance is shot by a man named Ransom Rance Stoddard. It's James Stewart in the movie. I want you to see that name, Ransom Rance Stoddard. The same, the Jewish value is the same English value as Under the Bridge and the Babushka Lady. Remember the Babushka Lady, TBL 223, inverted 322, 66. Any number of ways that are more than acceptable to look at that. So you do see for that, though, that 840, the killing name, absolutely coming up in the Babushka Lady there. And under the bridge, you see Satan and Moloch, the devil slash Satan. See Mark of Beast, that's the 666, triple ones that I've shown you so much of. You see up top 16, which I'm saying is in reference to this year, planned disaster. See accomplishment. All right, accomplishment is the idea of man bearing water, Illuminatus. Love is the law, USA president, and the fall of mankind. You also see in that same bit, Rosie Cross and building a world that makes it very, very difficult to refute. The only way you can really refute it is if you're just furling your eyebrow because this is so far over your head, you just say, fuck it. But that's not what you should do. Back to Ransom Rance Stoddard so you can see it. 7, Order of Rosicrucian, Obama's damaged right eye, the shells of the Klipoth. Bill of Rights author, it's James Madison, which I figure is absolutely coded out for something here. Do notice it is the same as Fortune X. Fortune is the 10th tarot card. X, obviously, the bit 410. You do see Hermetic Kabbalah, Conspiracy, 88, 411, Death Sentence, So Mote It Be, Tombstone, as well as Beginning and End. I'm sorry if my voice sounds weird. I've gone tone deaf in my left ear for some reason. And so do notice right now you also see the death of the Antichrist. One nation, one people, one leader, kill someone already, the slayer of men, order of the blue rose, and the church of desolation. I want you to see that the English and simple values are the same as Jesus fucking Christ, what Adele proclaimed Beyonce to be, as well as Walter Langland Cronkite and Hot Dogs Baseball Apple Pie. Again, that's from the Land trailer. It's inverted in the mirror that is hypnotizing a bunch of kids. You see Divine Gene, Archangel of Death, True Holy Angel of Death, Morningstar slash Lucifer in Impossible Coincidences. If we take a look at Ransom Stoddard without Rance in the middle there, the first thing that we see is 180. If we type in 180, you will see here that it is the English, or excuse me, is the simple value for CBS News Bulletin, the Master Builder, 444. Signs of deception, eyes of the world, all of that directly connected, all things I'm not but a breath away from having just discussed. Notice as well, collapse of America, four beasts in the secret places, it's all or nothing, Satan's church, and look at that, three fours. What more do you want? Here it is over for you again. And it's just like the moon. Notice that his English and simple values are the same as Anessa Wells, CNN, Erica Abbey Wright, Irvine, California, yada, yada, yada. I can't remember if there was another one in this thing from today, so that's the one from there. But do notice, United Nations, 22, Last Trumpet, Scottish Rite, Divide and Conquer, The Crown Snake, Homosexual Agenda, and 729. Again, that ever-important date. See how it comes up here in The Man Who Kills Liberty Valance, and all of these fours, and 22, and United Nations, and everything I've shown you up until this point. You shouldn't be watching this unless you've seen the first 2.5 hours. All right, so let's go back. I want you to see that after the killing, Peabody nominates Stoddard as the territory's delegate to Washington. I want you to see that there is a lot that is held against him, and they don't want him to hold that office because he agrees that he should not be entrusted with public service after killing a man in a gunfight. So seeing Stoddard's reluctance, Jonathon takes him aside and confides that he, Jonathon, actually killed Valance from an alley across the street, firing at the same time as Stoddard. Jonathon explains that he knows Hallie loves Stoddard and he shot Valance to secure her happiness. So after he tells him that, he's able to accept the nomination and is able to be the one to report to Washington. And so obviously you have a man taking the fall for him there. And this is so complex I didn't feel it necessary to go too much further into that man in the shadow, but maybe in one other video I'll bring him up. But notice here for Washington, since we've talked about everything from the Washington Monument to enthroned Washington to his birth date to Ralph Wiggum playing him to his role in Jebediah Springfield, Washington gives us the number 11, the flag of the United States of America and murder the Holy Ghost. The English and simple values give us the same as Minute Brew. It's the Nestle Nescafe commercial. Purple Rain, do not enter, and the dog has fleas. This is a quote from the Simpsons episode about Whacking Day, which for those of you who remember my old channel, I did a video on because it explains how the town of Springfield came to worship serpents, for Christ's sake. It's literally what the video is about. On the board, Marge wrote, "The dog has fleas," which appeared right after Bart was doing a multiplication table of 4 times 4. Okay, do you see that? You see terror, operation, threatening. Down below, again, those English and simple values. Rosicrucian, non servium, which means I will not serve, which is credited to Lucifer saying he won't serve God. White horse, seventh seal, black skeleton, that's from the tarot card. See the dollar bill, the blood of man, the path of Mem. It is the hanged man, the 12th card. Zachary Taylor was the 12th president. You see mysticism as well as the serpent. All right, so I include that in there, the serpent worship. And we're going to start rounding the bend here into the last bits of this presentation and getting into another episode of The Simpsons entitled I Love Lisa, in which I won't look at nearly as extensively, but which is very important because Ralph Wiggum, who is who I talk about here, because the head of Jebediah Springfield falls onto him after being decapitated, all of the connections I've shown you, I want you to see that for President's Day pageant, this Jewish value here, I want you to know that it is 1102. And when I talk about in my video about the date June 11th and the Pulse nightclub shooting and how it was said to start at 2:02, I want to talk about how this number 1102 and all of these connections right here, 1102 is what time it was on the West Coast when we heard about that, on June 11th still. Notice it's the same as Austin Zamora. This is the crane operator that I did the video on with Beyonce. All right, and so you do notice and remember that this English 948, 158 here, this has absolutely come up in this video for metaphorically. And when we're looking at that coding of the double 13, the tarot card reading, the inversions, notice this is bullet point 13. And when we invert it to 31, it's Camp Town Ladies, which has a Jewish value of 13, 13, the double 13. All right. All of this so immensely important. So let's get back here to 948. To 1102. And so again here for Austin Zamora and President's Day pageant. President's Day pageant, by the way, in this episode, is where Ralph is playing the role of George Washington. There's all these pictures here. So in this, in the opening of the President's Day pageant, Rod Flanders is presented as President Zachary Taylor. He's actually the first president that they mention in their little song and dance. And so here you see reference to building block upon building block, Simpson's theory, current 333, all right, everything I've talked about with the window seat cover for Erykah Badu. You see doctrine revealed, see unto this day, and factual evidence. And down below, the English and simple values, notice that inverted 322, but you also see Rigging International there, which was the company that put the Bay Bridge troll in place. It's obviously RI is 99, international rigging is another way to look at that. The human extinction, the synagogue of Satan, anything is possible, and secret numeric proof. Now I want you to see in this same episode, I Love Lisa here, we do see Bill and Hillary Clinton. And so remember, they were mentioned earlier in all of this. In Jebediah, in Obama Shot and Reborn, in Religious Idols, Kill, Magic, all of these things. I got hot sauce in my bag, which is something that Hillary said on the 109th day, which is coding I've shown you all up and down with this. When you go back, and in that same episode, it's this clip of Robert Frost in 1963 being interviewed by Krusty. So Robert Frost has the same English and simple values as unto this day, which President's Day pageant tells us to look into. So when you look into unto this day, you do see it's the same simple values, the Jewish note up there, as Aldous Huxley, the writer of Brave New World and Plan 9 Records, to released Bullet. You see Babylonian Brotherhood, Devil's Night, or Night's Devil. You see Wicked Man, Severe Hit, Racist, Extremist, and Savage Beast. The English and simple values down below are 666, as well as 33. You see As Above, So Below, Edward Crowley, 978, and Final Curtain Call. I have 978 highlighted as very important. And so you can see here that it is the same as Mayor Eric Hoag. And again, this is absolutely a number that has come up in this video today for Jebediah Springfield. Notice Mayor Eric Hoag is also the same as Nissan Stadium, the last place that that Beyonce is going to be playing her world formation tour. This is so awesomely connected. It is just beyond me. So with all of that, take a look at Ralph Wiggum here. Because he's the one whose dad has 666111 coding. He's the one whose dad, Police Chief Wiggum, exhumed and played with the corpse of Jebediah Springfield, with the founding father. Ralph Wiggum's dad, Police Chief Wiggum, made the town's founder sing Camp Town Ladies in front of a full moon. All right. And look at all of that coding. For the Great Babylon, MK Ultra, Mind Control and Ritual Abuse, all of these things I've talked about leading up to this third hour here. Forehead sign, Book of the Dead, Mark of Beast, The Golden Dawn, commits murder then suicide, Gematria of 33, to just showed you there connected with unto this day. Ralph Wiggum, who gets the ice cream to his right eye, Invisible Illuminati, 99, emblem of the Theosophical Society. You see, eye surgery, the word became flesh. I serve the darkness. Amen is the word, I know. Satanic spirituality and the devil uses black magic. The English and simple values are the same as I Slay Remix and East 8-3. And remember that 810. Not only being the number there of Ralph Wiggum's reduction, but 810 days, where is it here? Oh no, Oh no, it's 8 months, 10 days, okay, or 254 days, but 8 months, 10 days, 810 is the amount of time from when Don Trump said he could shoot somebody in Fifth Ave, and when Beyonce's World Formation Tour ends on October 2nd. All right, and Ricky Smiley, if we look at his birthday, is 810, again. You see that maintains there. And remember, his skit, Shot in the Right Eye, has come up so much today. It's unbearable. But you see, terrorism, Thelemic Order, Bohemian Grove, Black in the Sun, No Holds Barred, and The Final Step. So notice here for Ralph, 169 is the same simple value as Trump Tower and America Airlines. Again, going back to that cover for Erykah Badu's album, and so take a look at that as well, because Trauma Room 1, where Kennedy was pronounced dead, when you spell it out there, it's absolutely the same values as America Airlines and Trump Tower. And so if those are the numbers that they should be there, 1014, it's going to take us right to this. Remember, Trump Towers, both words, five letters, both start with T, 55, 22, 77. All right, so again, notice that symbol of 169 there, the golden-haired one, the number of 11, embodiment of evil, fire worshipper, and funding terror next to the 11th path. For the Jewish value of 169, you see outright thelema, parable, an image of God. Notice for Ralph here, and he happens to be number 55, his simple value is 55. English value is 330. Remember, this is where Rick Ross picks up Erykah Badu in the Window Seat remix video before they go on their killing spree. Satan, Judas, Wicked, Bones, New Age, and Laws. The last name, Wiggum, an occult conspiracy. Diseases of the Apocalypse, Final Warning, The Work. Murderville uses unholy magic and Machiavellian tactics. Remember, this is the idea that the ends justify the means. Notice the English and simple values are the same as Eric Fogel, who is the creator of Celebrity Deathmatch, as well as the word exhumed. You see Baphomet, Krishna, the Beast, Beelzebub, Worship, Sun God, Baptism, Offering, Tragedy, NASA Lies. So in this episode where Ralph plays the role of the president, you do see, of course, they get this brilliant Typhoon Apophis sign in there. But in this scene, and at the President's Day pageant, we're treated to a rendition of the assassination of Abe Lincoln. Of course, because that's one of the most steady themes that they run through this show, one of the most common recurring jokes for some reason. But Ralph's performance brings the audience to tears, because he's so impassioned. And before his lines begin, he burns the Valentine's Day card that Lisa had given to him, and it says, I choose you. And I've shown you this come up already in the coding before getting to here. But so notice the crescent moon behind him there, and obviously the connections that traditionally has to Lucifer. And the flames, of course, inhaling that. I want you to notice as well at the end of this performance that George Washington falls asleep. He dies. This flag has 13 stars on it. Of course, there are 13 stripes. There's another double 13, 4-4, or reference to Camptown Ladies, however you want to look at it. But it's absolutely coded through and through. So I want you to see here, for I choose you. You see the inauguration of Barack Obama, there is no such thing as time, and the rise of evil. The English and simple values are the same as the mysterious T in the Queen of Neo-Soul. The importance there is obvious. Master Mason's word, Declaration of Independence, and he who loves violence. Now notice inauguration starts with I, which is the ninth letter. It's a 12-letter word, so if we look at it as 912, remember that's the number that Homer is given when inaugurated into the secret group, the Stonecutters. If we reduce 12 down, we get 3, so we have 9-3, which is the master thelemic number. So inauguration is clearly a very important word. When you look at the word inauguration, you see very clearly the Jewish value 737, same as Rose City and Ticking Pendulum. So associated with the ideas of planet Saturn, soul contract, as well as an image in honor of the beast, okay? So you also see reference down there to Babylon is genocide. I'm trying to remember if this was earlier in the video as well. I'm not seeing it, so I'm not going to pull it for you. Oh, you know what it was? Was the 900-150 number. Nope. So notice that that English in simple value, though, Bay Bridge Troll 222, is the same as cholera morbus, the cause of death given to Zachary Taylor. You see forehead to be sealed, as well as 553, the number 396, 555, by the way. I mean, clearly I can't overstate the importance of it. From everything from 555 to Hubbard Avenue, to that being the height of the Washington Monument, being located on the same parallels as the George, or the same coordinate parallel lines as the George Washington Masonic National Museum. All of those things, that 555 is just so outwardly stunning. And so for notice for 396 written out, and again, inauguration, and this idea that we're getting here from I choose you, gives us the inauguration of Barack Obama, inauguration. English in simple values have the numbers 396 written out. 396 is the simple value for there is the dove and there is the serpent. So the two versions of love. You see the 33rd degree of Freemasonry as well as another government false flag operation and worship or reverence of Satan as a deity. Cannot emphasize the importance of that number occurring. You see divine justice, U.S. president, the word abrahadabra, which I showed you is coded the same as rose, which is also the same as ice cream. It's our words to signify the completion of the great work. You see biotechnology, harbinger of doom, spirit of death, CNN headline news, the wrath of God, Lucifer rising, and this means war. So as if all of that wasn't stunning enough, let's take one more look here. Jumping back, I believe, to this screen over here. Nope. Bear with me. So with Kearney and Jimbo decapitating Jebediah Springfield here, it's obviously important to look into that. You see the key of the Aeon of Horus, the deadly 49. Remember all the 49 connections I've shown you in here. You are so busted in work of art. Remember all the times I've shown you vitriol in here, and that is a code, an alchemical code that appears on the art card. All right, very, very important. So now going back, these English in simple value, Alan Kupperberg, to be continued, and day of reckoning. Now, Alan Kupperberg is the one who wrote this X-Men story that's going to be one of the last pieces that we get to look into today. But he's the one who wrote about Obnoxio the Clown. And this is the one that features the villain Ice Cream, Ice Cream, in his only appearance. Here you can see all the credits to Alan Kupperberg. Some more information about Ice Cream. All right, and I'm going to talk about him more in a minute. So going back here, do notice, and remember, to be continued, is from the end of the Window Seat Remix video, after we see the GB33ZB license plate and the gunshots, it says to be continued. Then you also see Day of Reckoning. And so, I can't help but feel like in this video it told us to see Day of Reckoning, but since I don't see it there, let's see over here. Beyonce X tells us to see the Day of Reckoning. And since I looked into this earlier in this video, it's important to include that, all right? And so again, the 3-6s, U.S., Babylon, all these references here, Serpent of Enlightenment, Austin is Toth, Holy Sacred Force. Okay, so Day of Reckoning has the same as all of these. 888. Love of money. You see the breakdowns for Freddy Krueger. 94. Same simple value as Mike Will, Sasha Fierce. Number of other things that have come up in this video, you're going to see in just a second here, is also the same simple value as Ice Cream, that X-Men character, okay? But so you do see esoteric skulls, do the math. When you do the math for these English and simple values, you get the number 444. Absolutely no coincidence to that. Notice as well, I am the Phoenix, ruler of Earth, the demonic elite, sublime new era, and 853. 853 brings us right back to the beginning of this episode with the Brady Bunch being the baseline here, the 222. Remember George Washington, born February 22nd, fictional reality, strange sense, X. Notice the Beyonce X, and I told you in that video it was fucking weird to me. I had it referenced that way. Down below, English and simple is just like Charles Dickens, the Boondocks, John F. Kennedy, death penalty, serial killer, and the great beast. Okay. So Ice Cream, this weird Marvel comic character's name, the 619 coding is the same as cholera morbus, which is Zachary Taylor's stated cause of death. Learn to read gematria, murder addiction, and the rose eaters. These are the people who hide the secrets. English and simple values, as I just stated, but they are the same to fully recap here now as terror, obnoxio. Remember the clown that premieres in this particular X-Men comic book. Terror, Sasha Fierce, Queen Bey, Mike Will, Black Boxes, and Groupthink. So notice that obnoxio has the same Jewish value as 501, has a Jewish value of 501, which is the same as Dallas Magic Clubs, which is the same as a real cup of coffee, which is directly connected to Nestle Nescafe. Dallas Magic Clubs, if you'll remember back in my video here, talking about David Copperfield, talking about Mayor Eric Hoag, talking about clowns, talking about the number 15 and the devil card that it is, talking about Dallas Magic Clubs, all right? Absolutely the group that he's a part of. The camera cannot lie. Used books, the goat of Mendes, crosshairs, honor ritual, bed of pink roses, all right? Look down below, English and simples, same as Dallas Love Field, Freemasonry, an eye for an eye. Masks of Satan and Imperial Cult. And see, we just come back and back and back. So I want you to see that Ice Cream character. If we pop back here, you can see he's from Earth 616, collection of the X-Men. So if you type that in, it's the same as I choose you. All right. The fuck out of here. The inauguration of Barack Obama. The rise of evil. English and simples. Same as East 11 Ingress. The formula of Inri. Instant Nescafe Coffee. Barnyard Studios. R Cloud 55. Exclusive details. Wensler Winery. And 1914. That is a good clip of so many of the things that I happen to have covered with this. I want you to see, because I never brought this one up, but this is from the episode Tom, Sarah, and Usher, which is coded in that Brady Bunch stuff and a lot of other stuff I showed you. But check this out. Wensler Winery, WW55, 1914. I just showed you there, all right, all of that coded the same. Exclusive details. It's from the article talking about Beyonce and the crane operator. Obviously, the Nestle Nescafe Barnyard Studios is where it was either Fear of the Dark or Number of the Beast was recorded. In either case, very important. But so notice for Earth 616, on top of all of that, and the fact that you see a 114 and 19 and everything I've talked about with those, Aleister Crowley, Synagogue of Satan, 111, the United States, tyrant ruler, Rosicrucian order, history is bunk, FEMA internment camps, the four horsemen. Get the number 133, which I have written not only as something for Sandra Bullock, who was one of the two stars in the movie Gravity, but let's see if we can pull it up for you here. I want you to be able to see it. This is a hoax. Government, Book of the Law, Mysteries, Masonic Cipher. It's the same as Warner Brothers, as well as Indian Love Call. It's the song that destroyed aliens and Mars attacks and English Nadsat, which is the made-up language. And the book Clockwork Orange, okay, things that I talked about on my old channel and it got banned. Also notice that 133 is the same as Erica Abby Wright. Now, this is actually her birth name, the way it is spelled without the Y. Do notice here, again, reference to Phoenix Resurrection, Cover of Darkness, and the 165, which is something that is ubiquitous throughout all of this. And we did just see the 165 back here a moment ago. We saw all the way towards the beginning in there with the 55 times 3. You also saw it coming up in reductions for Jebediah Springfield, but is the actual simple coding for Ransom Stoddard. And then again, you see the connections to Erica Abbey Wright with the Y, as well as page 35, the written formula of Tetragrammaton. And do remember that page 35 is in Aldous Huxley's Brave New World, the point in which he elaborates on the beginning of the 9 Years' War. So again, Ransom Stoddard, the one who took, or at least thought that he shot, Liberty Valance, and all of those connections, all right? So, wow, that's how that 133 connects for you there. The 165 that we get from looking into it one step farther. Now I want you to see here, for this reference down here, see pale pan. It's from Ice Cream. It tells us to see pale pan. And so for all of these, we are also told to see pale pan. So notice that the Jewish value is 187, which is the police code for homicide. As if that's not important enough. But do notice that is the same simple value as the age of aquariums. This is from the Family Guy episode. Yod, Resh, Non, or Nun, Ra, Yod, excuse me, spelled out there. That is the written out formula of Inri. It's also the same as Full Flower Moon. But take a look through here, because you see it is the same as George Washington. The Death of Humankind, Brotherhood of Death, Concealed Mystery, The Lord of the Flies, Love is the Reason, and Let the Earth Rejoice. Stunning. But when it's a Jewish value, notice that we have Bones, Fallen One, Horned, Kill Chief Barak, Baraks, The Line, Hello Obama. Remember, Hello is the same coding as Devil, so you could look at it like that, as well as God Blood. And this idea of Obama's age, he's currently 54, but will be turning 55, this masterful, beautiful number on August 4th. Scary stuff. Notice his English and simple values are the same as Prince. Simple value of 65, remember, is the year, or the age that Zachary Taylor and Stuart Gilbert died at. Gilbert Stuart. Do notice here, 7, 15. Florida, things that we've talked about immensely through here. I want you to see in my integration of soft ice cream, the line from Lana Del Rey's song Salvatore, which absolutely is critical to look at in connection with all of this. Your whole album is really. So there's that for you on the side. That's the length of the song is 4 minutes, 41 seconds. I just want to pull it up for you over there. So that you can see what's connected with that song. And I do have soft ice cream. Or at least I thought I did. Let's see if it's over. You know what? If it's... Oh, that's why. It's because there's that spelled with that in the front there. So... apologies there, but so notice for soft ice cream from the song Salvatore, you saw right back there, Forehead to be Sealed, Death Brotherhood, all of that. Notice that soft ice cream is the same coding as Rena Flores. And so Rena Flores is the one who wrote the CBS article for Trump saying that he could shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue and not get in trouble for it. Again, his stupid little 666 hand sign there. Something that somebody could make a video on and get just millions of views, and it just detracts so much from the deep, complex information that is absolutely here. All right, so take a look here as well. Because not only do we see all of that, but I want you to notice as well that it looks like soft ice cream, if it would have came up for me right earlier, is the same coding as syphilis, Fifth Avenue, and Cascadia Rising. Remember, syphilis is what they discover or speculate that Jebediah's actual cause of death was, and you saw the reference to Desolate Measure, so on and so forth, the Prince of Darkness. And so remember, Fifth Avenue, everything we just said was soft ice cream, sharing the same coding as Rena Flores, who reported on a shooting on Fifth Avenue. Notice three nines, Lord of Silence, Church of Baal, Bed of Roses, and Hate Mongering. All right, that is an absolutely stunning one. So when we change it around a little bit and we integrate soft ice cream into this here, you'll notice that we get reference to channeling of Almighty God. So many things, as in the scope of these videos. Dying Day, Enslaved, Fanatical Terrorists, Kills People for Sport, and Gate of the Abyss. I want you to see that the English and simple values for this are the same as Anthony Kiedis, Kiss Love Gun, Earth Space Defense, Ricky Smiley, 38E, Black Boxes Found, and Black Boxes Located. All things that I've talked about in connection to this set of events, telling you that June 11th was going to be an important day, telling you I really, really think that July 29th will be important, telling you that I thought May 14th was important, and that's when Kiedis was hospitalized. And all of these things, Ricky Smiley on June 11th, all of the In the Right Eye stuff that I've talked about. Notice here, the Antichrist, Queen of Babylon, Lord of the Flies, the Law of Thelema. I know I keep reiterating these, but it is important to get my point across. Restoration, America the Babylon, Satanic Truth, I Am the Great Beast, Get Your Goat, and Evil Billionaire. So now with all of that in place, the soft ice cream, the Pez, the 44 pieces, everything. Like I said, if you're at this point and you have not watched the other videos, I don't care if you don't understand it. I don't. Notice here the pizza subs underneath of Zesties. It's the same English value, this 1452, as starts, miracles, and enders. And so this connects it very heavily with that Family Guy episode. You see Fall of the United States, Humanity's Tombstone, Brotherhood of Saturn, the ends of manifestation, the number of the last day, which is 729. Notice it tells you on the left side of the screen for a Jewish value of 1452 to see Bavarian Illuminati. Sorry, I've been doing fair. Yeah. Sorry. So, when you look into the coding for Bavarian Illuminati, oh, it took me a second there, been doing this is almost 3.5 hours straight. The Jewish value is 1272, which is the same English value as Don King versus Donald Trump. The English and simples are the same as Lisa Respers France, Trump Towers, and Down, Bayhive Down. Remember, Lisa Respers is the one who did the Decoding Beyonce's Lemonade article. You see this idea to read secret reality from this. And the phrase read secret reality is death by burning Just like when Ralph burned the I choose you card. See, kill those of Antichrist. Aliens are one of the plagues. The English and Simples, the same as Commerce Bank Arena. Andrew Rannells and Susanna Jones. Again, satanic rulers, Luciferian Mason, Obama damage, right eye, devil worship, and mystical arts. So remember, with having just seen reference to the number of the last day, and then to get thrown back into this secret reality, which is coded the same as Commerce Bank Arena, that is absolutely going to be on what very well could be one of the last days. Frankfurt, Germany, all the connections I showed you to get here. Notice back on this side, pizza subs. And again, 64. For those of you who have the capacity to appreciate this, it's the same simple value as Amon and Clow, as well as the land, amen. It's the same as chosen. It's the same as Thelema. It's the same as the chief, awakened, encoder. All of these things. 64, written out, comes up in the formula of Inri, which also pops up next to the written out formula of Tetragrammaton, United States, Ultraviolence, and Four Horsemen. It's also the same as Bring Me Home Live and Quiet Storm. All of this connected. All of this crucial. All of this so very critical. You see reference to the number 411 or 1104. Everything we've talked about, 11 times 4, then giving us a nice 44 in there as well. You see UN Security Council, and the Bible can actually hurt faith. Yes, sir. Notice for pizza subs, it's the same English simple values as Dallas Love Field, which is where Kennedy was heading when he was assassinated. It's also the same as Judas My Guide. Song that is 3 minutes 6 seconds long off of Iron Maiden's Fear of the Dark album. Heavily, heavily connected. Freemasonry. 69. God is the Devil. Masks of Satan. I am the Dark Lord. As well as Ancient Egypt and Imperial Cult. And so that's it. That's the PEZ theory. Walking through everything from NASA to the digging up of presidents, to the assassination of presidents, to albums, to episodes, to paintings, to monuments. And look here at this number 107 coming up in the PEZ theory. I want you to remember, let's see if I've got it in here, that you see, for the tongue prosthetic, it's 107. In another episode that I could have talked about called The Telltale Head, in which they decapitate, this is where Bart originally decapitates Jebediah Springfield's statue. In the beginning, you have this 107 hidden here. I could do a whole video about this one as well, because it is absolutely fascinating. But that 107, and all the different ways it comes up in here, the fact that it came up coded for Zachary Taylor as well, just shows you how crucial the PEZ theory is. Notice as well, Illuminati are the Serpent Seed Bloodline, Obelisk Tower, what I'm thinking is a reference to the Washington Monuments, the world's tallest. Obelisk Tower, you see, Maker of New Earth, the Evilest Human, think what you will. Wielding a pitchfork, dead, rising from the grave, Masonry, a Scottish Rite, and Civil Rights Streak. Again, the English and simple values are the same as Jonathon Collier, the writer for Lisa the Iconoclast. Let Him March, Boys, which is Police Chief Wiggum, you see, coded the same. His response to the breaking of the law at the end of this episode, and is directly coded with Obama's shot and right eye. So before I reiterate that one more time, do notice the great architect, the number 7, the supreme key, hit the bullseye, hiding the truth, order of the rose, Hurricane Katrina, which I say is a formation reference, because remember in her formation video, she dies on a New Orleans police car. You see, just wait and see, as well as Obama executioner. The PEZ theory, number of letters in each word is 336. This is the same Jewish value as Obama's death call, right brain, gloom and doom, satanic dogma. It's the same English and simple values as ISIS, will, the end, attack, Moloch, and warn. Remember all the way back 3.5 hours ago when I started this and showed you that this watch and learn feature at the beginning of the Least of the Iconoclast episode ends with the words "the end" on the American flag. And everything I've walked you through and the PEZ theory linking right up with it, as well as the ideas of Obama's death call, right brain, satanic dogma, the end, and warn. Alright, you can try to downplay it all you want as petty or insignificant, but my videos are the ones being banned. I'm the one who's being repressed in trying to tell you this shit. So I really don't care if you do not agree or if it's over your head. If it's over your head, you need to think harder. PEZ theory, same as John F. Kennedy, British Broadcasting Corporation, 223. It's an inverted 322. 22 times 3 is 66. It's like the number of points in the PEZ theory. Revelation 3, knowing that these words are important. Jim Carrey, the star of The Truman Show, in which people are watching us from the moon, controlling his reality, and he lives in apartment 36. 36, the 36 triangular number is the 666. Jim Carrey as the leader of some LA branch of occultism. Jim Carrey, whose name is 3 letters and 6 letters. Jim Carrey, whose initials J and C are 13, the death card. Nuclear physicist, bred for war, Royal Society, warns Barack. The divine plans of God, and this is the Zodiac speaking. The English and simples of this, as I stated for you in the very beginning of the PEZ theory, go across everything that I have talked about on this new channel. Not only that, but the simple value of 138 in the We Are 138 that I have so steadfastly warned you of is only further testament. You see Donald Trump, Clancy Wiggum, Beyonce Lemonade, Sade Bring Me Home, The Brothers, Cat William, A Real Cup of Coffee, Master Mason, Behind the 11, God Bless Satan, Great Architect, you see 911 call, I Hear Horsemen, Looks Can Fool, Secret Key Code, Higher Wisdom, Long Overdue, and Religion is a Facade. So that's the PEZ theory. Any bit of it that you take from this, I would greatly appreciate if you give me proper credit, because I know that a lot of my videos are coveted for information by bigger channels. Something that I deal with, it's whatever. But know that I inspire a lot more people than the ones you're led to believe. Know that these videos get huge numbers, likes, playlist, the likes don't quite add up. Because when I go through and I look at the number of videos and playlists, there are hundreds per the heavy-hitting videos. And when I look at it, the people who are putting it in playlists are not subscribed. And I don't understand. Don't covet this information. Show your support. All right? You cannot copy this stuff because it is so authentic. Don't try to emulate it. Give it its proper credit. I really appreciate you for taking the time, for those of you who made it all the way through, and it's for those of you who have made it to this point that everything is clearest. And you are destined to have this understanding for whatever purpose that might be. And so with that, I say thank you again for watching, and please, Please be well.